Bam. Hey everybody, how you doing? It's me, Lewis. Monday streams, normally I'm here with Duncan or Tom or Ben or someone else, but tonight it's just me. So I thought we'd play some Civilization 6. We are on time. We are live. I did a straw poll earlier on my Twitter. Who shall I play as tonight on the stream? England was slightly ahead. I don't know if I should do like a runoff of the top three. Like do a re-straw poll. Do you know what? We've only got 3 hours. So let's just get going, shall we? I've been playing a little bit of this game. I'm fairly familiar with it. I could talk to you all day about this, so maybe I will. Thank you to Dave for resubbing. Thank you to Vooz TV who subbed. I'm just gonna go for it as best I can, right? And try and talk to you guys about my thoughts and my feelings playing as Victoria in England. Let me know if you have any questions and I will answer them. Okay, so I'm gonna start a game as Victoria. Bam. From the first stirrings of life, we're not gonna worry too much about Sean Bean. The great beast. A Civ game should take about more than 3 hours, a little bit. But I'm gonna see if I can get through the whole thing on the stream. Now begins. I'm just gonna slam on with it. Paul Turner 76, loving the streams, you sexy bastard. Make me horny so horny. Thanks, Paul. That's nice. Extend your reach beyond your borders and across the unique advantage of old Victoria is the Royal Navy dockyard, which I was really hoping to build. However, this start does not have a coast. I had planned for this, guys. I've planned for this. I made another save where there was a coast. Because I really wanted to build a Royal Navy dockyard. So this is the unique district. Doesn't actually say what it does on here. I can't actually remember what it does either. I've never played as England before. I don't think England's one of these civs which is naturally really, really strong. Okay, so already in Civ 6, I've found that certain civilizations are very, very strong. Right out of the gate, okay? So, like Rome, really super strong. Certain other civs are super strong, but I will talk to you about those differently. So this is a save I just generated while we were prepping for the stream, and I thought this one looked interesting, which is why I called it interesting. So, okay, let me start off with you guys. So the first thing you want to find out whether you want to do is move the settler. I'm on the coast here with a lake as well. I could build a harbour in a lake if I wanted to. I probably wouldn't do it in that lake. I would like to build my harbour either here or here or here or here. Okay, I can build it in any of these tiles because they're all adjacent to land. But I want to build it adjacent to the sea tile. Harbours get bonus gold when you build them next to a sea tile. Okay, so +1 gold for every adjacent coastal resource. And obviously all the districts have bonuses for being next to two districts. Okay, so if I build the harbour here, it'll count as being next to my capital, which is obviously good for it. The other thing I get is if I want to build a commercial district, that gets +2 gold for being adjacent to a harbour and +2 gold for being adjacent to a river. So it doesn't actually get bonuses for multiple sides touching the river, as I thought originally. It only gets it from one side. So you should try... I'm immediately thinking already about where I want to put stuff. So I see this.
No good at staying straight.
I don't really need to think too much about the orientation of my city this early, but I'm going to. So I'm thinking like harbour here. You know, I'm going to be England, so can I settle on the coast? Probably, but I'd rather have a commercial district on a river adjacent to this tile. So I'm thinking already, I want to move somewhere. So if this was a multiplayer game, moving back from the coast would be fine. But look at this, like, inlet. I mean, them having to come into my inlet sounds like a nightmare for them to do. So, yeah, I'm already, like, deliberating what to do here. The other alternative is to move here, which gives me slightly less fresh water than I would have done had I not been here. Okay, so fresh water's the thing that you want to learn, right? So I'm on a river at the moment, which is 3 fresh water. Coastal water is only 1. I could move here. This would be the worst. And then I can cut this forest down, and we've got a desert tile. We could probably build the pyramids on there. Right. Give me a little bit of time to make a decision here, and let me know what you think too. Okay, so Sean Hardin, 101. Okay, Lou, you can be in charge of my civilization, if you know what I mean. Don't know what that means. Dark Phoenix, hey Lewis. Before too many more YouTube commenters rip their dicks off, you can't nope a defuse in exploding kittens. That was a while back we played that. Or was it the weekend? Was the last one the weekend? Maybe the last one went out that week. I can't remember. But we recorded those so long ago. Got to say, loving watching you and Dunk play strategy games very much. Also, liking Project Ozone as a series. I did just want to play a Minecraft series with Duncan where it's just playing Minecraft. And I actually got Jaded Cat, who made A Grey in Skies, messaged me and said, hey, do you want to come to this thing at Minecon? And I was like, I'm not going to Minecon, but I love A Grey in Skies, by the way. And she was like, oh, cool. And I was like, do you recommend any packs we should be playing? And she was like, I'm really enjoying playing Project Ozone. So that's why we're doing that. Snarkiest Hour says, build that Civ, bitch. Thanks. And DJ Sand says, hello. Oscar Lert says, would you come into my inlet? Wow. So normally, like, I play Civ like I'm playing a multiplayer game, even just to kind of, like, give me that idea of a real competitive. Because at the moment, Civ isn't very threatening. The AIs, the barbs are a bit scarier than the AIs in this game at the moment. But if I generated this in a multiplayer game, I'd be very tempted to build on the coast. But building, it's fine. We're gonna go here. Do you know what? We're going here. This is a crazy thing to do. But the reason I've actually done it is because we got a banana, decent tile here. We want to make sure we're working a 2 food, 2 production tile to begin with, or at least the 2 food tile. There's a couple of good bananas here. I'm thinking industrial district here. I'm thinking harbour here, commercial district here. I mean, it does get rid of a really nice tile. This is a so this tile you would build. We still have one of my arms, you understand, but an arm. We still have a text to speech on. Thanks for that. I didn't get much of that, but I'm just gonna carry on. I'm just gonna play this game. I'll maybe do like a sort of a thoughts video at some point in the future. But until then, I'm just gonna play and see how it goes. So my usual starting setup, okay, is scout into builder. So I'm gonna want mining and animal husbandry here, which is okay. I might do something a bit weird here, but I think what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna go builder, farm, chop these down and chop this down. And then that'll boost my second builder. And then after that builder, I might get settler. Depending on how the barb situation is, and also if I found a good spot for a second city. We'll find out. Okay, so yeah, I'm really enjoying Civ 6 at the moment. This is the best bit of the game for me. It's the exploring and the deciding what to do. I think it'd be fun to build the pyramids. We might try and do that. I think it's possible to do that as well. There's a barbarian scout there. He looks like he came from this way, which is obviously slightly worrying. I do want to see what's up here, because I feel like this is just the end of the world up here. Unfortunately, there probably is a city. And moving away from this tile is a real shame. Because look at that, 5 resources on 1 tile at the start of the game. That seems like a lot of resources. And I want all of that. You know, if it was like 3 food and 2 gold, I'd be like, ugh. But 3 food and 2 production, I want all of that. Unimproved, there's no one there too. So maybe a city like on up here somewhere that makes use of both of these. So if I get sailing, I guess I can just move the settler straight. Oh, I can't climb up these cliffs though. We're going to send the settler around this way. Let's see what we get. We are a coastal civ, so we might as well settle on the coast. And this game, we're basically going to be like, hey, we've already settled the coast. That gives us a boost to sailing anyway, right? So we've already boosted sailing. I found this quite difficult to boost because I hate to settle cities on the coast in this game. There's like almost no reason to do so. Buildar. All right, we're going to just have a peek through this jungle. More coast here. Interesting. A little tribal goody hut. Fantastic.
Who deserves more credit?
This warrior. I'm gonna loop this warrior around and have him come back, I think, because barbs can be a little bit of a problem. Heracles. Yeah, I don't really care. He's gonna reveal his capital to me though, hopefully. So, oh, it's down here. So I don't really want to explore here because it looks like his warrior's probably gone.
That turns me
either this
on.
Way and or this way. So I'm thinking, turn around right now. Just go up here. I'll get that next turn. So I got mining, and I am going to now get the other thing I want, which is probably going to be hooking up either of these, hooking up this animal husbandry. So we're working these tiles. That seems fine. I can purchase a tile, and I will. I think I'm okay with getting this builder done slightly sooner. And we're gonna walk up this hill. Oh God. Okay, a bit messy. A bit messy, but okay. I don't see any particularly nice locations in this. Ah, I got the goody hut. It had bronze working in it. That's interesting. So because I got bronze working early, boosted, I might be able to just slam up to here, reveal iron, see if there's iron anywhere, and then also be able to cut down rainforest too. So I could consider chopping down some of this rainforest as a resource. So I really see, you've got to see these bonus resources here as, these are bonus resources too. You've got to see them as kind of either immediate boosts to your empire if you need them, or and forests too, right? So what I'm going to do is, or in the long term, you can leave them there for gains. So here's what I'm going to do. Oh, right, okay. Well, we found a new continent as well, by the way. So this is actually the continent of Amasia. This is Avalonia. That actually triggers our second civic, which is this one, to get a trader. I actually want this one first, if I can get it, which does require to improve three tiles. So typically, my first builder will be to improve three tiles, because this then allows me to get out a slinger much, much cheaper. I'm just going to stop telling you stuff and just carry on with the way I'm going to play it. I'll make a video about strategy and stuff later. Maybe if I have time. They want me to construct a campus. Am I the first person to meet them? Yeah, so I've got the envoy already. Plus two science. It's boosted my science all the way to 5. Well, it will do next turn. 5.6. So that's like almost doubled my science. City-states are pretty spooky. So, there's a barbarian scout here, which is annoying. So barbarians, when they scout you, they run back to their camp and bring troops. They run back to their camp and they will spawn like a stuff and bring it back and attack you, which is kind of not what I really want. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to build a second builder. Actually, I'm going to build a farm, which will give me irrigation sooner than normal. irrigation is something which is nice. You can build the hang gardens if you want, which is actually okay. And if you need any plantations, then obviously that's the thing you're going to need, especially if you've got a plantation luxury. I don't actually have any luxury. Oh, no, that's my luxury. Oh, bollocks. Well, I'm going to need the luxury at some point. I only need the luxury when I get to 5 pop, though. Amenities aren't really a problem till I get to 5 population. Let's work on foreign trade. Let's work on craftsmanship. We're going to work on craftsmanship until we get halfway done, and then we're going to stop. Okay. We haven't actually found any religious city-states or picked up a relic or got a religious tile. There's a bunch of ways to get a little bit of faith coming in, right, early in the game. But we haven't got any of those. Now, do we really care about a pantheon? Well, we got 2-3 stone. So stone circles is too bad. However, one of them is out of range. Where's our second city going to be? Probably on the border with Greece. I would guess it would be around here, right? And the reason it would be around there is because if this was a player, we'd want to secure this land before he could. Because it's obviously a sort of contested border area. If he expanded onto this river, which he obviously would do, it's about 1, 2, 3, 4, 5... about 6 tiles from him. It's about 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. It's about 7 from me. So he'd probably want this river system more than I would. So I'm thinking I'd probably go and settle here early before he can. That might be a bit difficult. We'll find out. I'll start bringing this guy back round to do it. So by the time I have a settle, it'll be fine. Oh yeah, but I mean, when you're picking a policy, obviously, we're not actually fighting barbs at the moment, so we can slap in the double experience for scouts. And do we care about a pantheon? I think we do want a pantheon eventually, and this is the only way we're going to start getting some faith ticking towards it. We could do stone circles. There's no more stone down here, but it's not a bad one. Obviously God of the Sea, one production off that. Any of the faith pantheons aren't much good here, unless this is a very big desert and we want to expand to it. This is all plains, I think. Yes, this is all grassland. These are plains. I mean, this is a desert, but it's a shit desert, i.e. there's no hills in it. This might be a decent desert with some floodplains. I don't know. Strategic view. Strategic view is actually very useful for telling us, like,
if there are no
where
dogs
things are going.
In
here. Okay. Has it changed my worked tiles? It has. I wonder why. All right, so that's 2 turns till growth. That's 1 turn till growth. I think that's probably what we want, then. We'll grow. I do want to consider getting my luxury set up at some point, but it's really not a priority. We're not going to mine any resources, so that's annoying. We could think about cutting down this rainforest. That might actually not be terrible. Might want to hook up this banana. But I think putting a plantation on here gives +1 gold, which we give no fucks about, so it might be worthless. There's a potential to put a campus. Campuses are good adjacent to rainforests. So could put a campus here. Then we'd have to put a district here of some description, which isn't impossible. Maybe we won't get a campus in our first city. We're gonna chop that forest next turn. Okay, let's read some donations. Barium says, "Damn, I love Civ. I would give an arm to play Civ 6 without having to wait for a release. Not one of my arms, you just understand, but an arm." Okay, Barium, sure. Someone else's arm. Grenstone 4, thanks. sexy robot lady. Hey, Lewis, it's me, your sexy robot lady. You look hot settling cities. Hit me up for some RAM after you're finished. Craig Esser. Thank you. Kasar81. Lewis, I know you spend a lot of time in Civ 5 micromanaging the city tasks rather than using the city focuses. Are the city focuses in Civ 6 any smarter, or do you still need to micromanage the tasks for optimal effect? Well, actually, they are much better, actually. Just clicking food and production pretty much handles it. They don't tend to work gold at all in that case. They don't prioritize it at all. I mean, sometimes if you don't do this, though, and you have like a 2 food, 2 gold tile, sometimes your city will work that, and it's like, wow, that is not what you should be doing. So you just slam these on, and it's fine. It's great. 404, timeout not found. 8 months, resubs. Thank you. Practicing for the Civ 6 multiplayer already, Lewis? Try hard? Try hard much? Well, if I'm going to be 4v1, which is almost guaranteed, then, you know. Eldaro, what is your most favourite and least favourite Civ? I think England is shit and China is the best, and I'm not just saying that because I'm Scottish. England is legit the worst Civ. By the way, you can't nope a defuse card. We've been through this. Thank you, Eldaro. We have been through this. I think I haven't tried China and Egypt yet. So China's unique ability, I think, is the one where if you're building a district, you can slam a builder on there and plug his work into production, which is really cool, actually, a really, really cool idea. And Egypt's is really cool as well, because you start building a wonder, you just slam a worker on there, and he will start turning that stuff into the good stuff, and that's what you want, right? I'm just wondering whether... Currently, I'm really interested in the idea of harvesting resources, okay? This is a big thing in Civ, and I think I'm just wondering how much you can do it to get an early game boost. Because it used to be in Civ, right, that you could, in Civ 4 anyway, that one of the big things was chopping. So that's what I'm going to be doing next turn when I figure out what I want to research. I think I'm just going to quest towards bronze working, because I think it might actually be a really cheeky tactic. If I just chop a bit of rainforest down, I think it might give me a lot of resources. Right, we're going, I want to see what's up here. Oh shit. Not very much, apparently. See, I was scouting this out for a city spot. It's not the worst, because mountains function like fresh water, right? So if I settled a city here, okay, and this was another block and there was the coast here. So if this was a city without any fresh water, it would be shit, because it would grow to like 2 before it needs more housing. I mean, London already needs housing, right? So we're at 3 out of 4 housing already in London, which is awful. So what I really need to do is probably go and build a granary. I can't actually build a granary yet. See, this is the problem with playing without settling on a river. If you settle on the coast instead, you get this housing issue, and it's already stopping my people building by 50%. So I need 50% more food to get them growing, which is an awful lot, actually, and very frustrating. But that can be countered by a quick granary, which gives you 2 housing. And then obviously later in the game, it was countered by building an aqueduct to fresh water. But I can only build the aqueduct either here or here. So that would involve removing a farm, which is not that bad, or building it here, which I don't really want to do, because I want to build the commercial district there, commercial district harbour. I know it's not, then again, it's not all that good. I'm still not sure whether this is the right decision or not. It's the decision we're going with, though. We are going to chop, like we said we would, and get this guy out over here. And then he's going to chop that next turn as well. And we are going to build a settler now, might as well, seeing as our food's fucking garbage. We're not going to grow anyway. Let's have a look. Pericles wants to see our capital, which I'm cool with. What's that noise? I don't know. We have found another city-state. They want me to train spearmen. They give me +2 production while building wonders, buildings, and districts. That's helpful. That'll be helpful for when I'm building that granary, which I probably ought to build immediately, actually. So let's change the science over. We'll get this guy out to here. Get this guy over to here. This guy's going to get used up, so it'll be his third charge. So this guy will use this charge. And then maybe go and build on that. Don't really need to. Not sure. I'll think about it in a minute. Right. Anonymous says, happy early birthday. And donated $100. Holy shit. Thank you. That's a nice birthday present. I'm also going to get rid of this woods. Ready? There you go. Okay. So it's now 3 turns until settler is finished, which is cool. Once this gets to halfway, I'm going to stop. But I think I might be okay, you know.
As it turns out, Mount Kilimanjaro is not Wi-Fi enabled. So I had to spend 2 weeks in Tanzania talking to the people on my trip.
That's horrible. So that is another city-state? Or was it a player? I think it's a player because it's got a coloured bit on it. That must be Japan. Okay, cool. We found Japan, guys. So this is Kilimanjaro. What good... Look at these food tiles. They're incredible. So maybe I shouldn't send my first settler down here. Maybe I should send him up here. But maybe this is going to be uncontested anyway. So let's have a good old scout around here. My settler's going to be done so soon. This guy's going to be nowhere near back to able to defend it. So maybe I should just run him up here and hope for the best. I'm worried about that barbarian scout. I guess he's probably bringing guys back already. Well, we'll find out, won't we, next time. These are hills, so they're going to cost me an entire turn to move on to. Okay, there's no there's no barbarian there, which is a mild relief. My scout is available for promotion. These are both hills and grasslands, so they cost 3 to move to. So I can't move and promote. I could move and promote with that, but I'm going to just promote him now. Promoting takes this whole turn. I'm giving you all of like the hottest Civ 6 tips here. So now I can just run into here. Oh my god. What am I finding here? Kabul. Construct an encampment. These first guys. Okay, so these are the best city states to meet. Prostitute production in the capital when producing units. Everything I'm producing pretty much is a unit. Settlers a unit, builders a unit. I'm going to build a slinger in a minute, that's a unit. Let's get this improved, and this will be the boost for craftsmanship. Bam. All right. I had to keep my eye on that because I didn't want to over-research it. Pottery's finished. So that means we can build the granary, which we probably should build at some point. Not yet, though. I think I might chop down another forest. Or maybe I'll go and chop down this rainforest. Who knows? We're going to grow anyway for some reason. We're growing because we've added some housing by making farms. So we're now up to 5 housing. We were only at 4 before. And so we are going to grow. We're growing at full rate at the moment. Once we hit 4 pop, we're going to grow less, but we're going to lose a pop from producing this settler. So I think we'll lose a pop. We'll be down to 2 for a turn. Unless I can get enough food together. Which we're already at max, so I can't. Unless this will give us... Unless this will do it in 1 turn. No, it won't. Okay, never mind. Let's just unlock all the tiles. So we can choose. And we're going to research... I think we're going to research... masonry. And maybe build the pyramids at some point. There's lots to build. I'm going to resume bronze working.
Skill without imagination is...
So we haven't got our pantheon yet, and we haven't found any religious city-states. We found other ones, which is still unfortunate, so we're going to have to keep this here. We're going to swap out double recon for 50% production on ranged units. Ah, shit, we just found a religious sea state. However, I don't think we're the first to find them. We're not, so we're not going to get any faith from it. We're not going to get an envoy for about 41 turns. So that's not really a problem for us. Right, where are we going to put the city? I'm thinking, like, here, actually. That seems really good. It's going to take fucking ages to get there, though, because of all that rainforest. How long until I can research sailing? 3. That doesn't actually allow other units to embark. It only seems to allow builders to embark, so maybe I'm going to have to run anyway. My god, look how many turns it's going to take me to get there. That is a long-ass place to go, but it's pretty good. We're going to go there. And we're going to see if we can hopefully not have our settler die on the way. I'm not covering him super well, I must admit. But that's life. That's life. Didn't drop a pop. Well, we did drop a pop, but we obviously had enough food that it just took us straight back up to 3 in that turn. We're going to continue with foreign trade because it's, boosted. Let's hope for the best. Pericles is saying we're cool with 6 states. I'm not sure what that actually fucking means. Does that mean, like, he's going to kill it or what? This is my warrior. Oh. A tribal hut has somehow survived in the middle of the desert. It's quite an interesting little desert here. So there's a religion called, there's a pantheon called, well, obviously desert folklore. But desert folklore is a bit weird because it only gives, if I plonk down like a holy site here that had desert folklore, it would get +6 faith per turn. And then if I also, for example, plonked down, if I also use the civic, which gives it +100% adjacency bonus, I'll be getting 12 faith per turn, which seems like quite a lot, right? But that's, you know, dedicating a lot of resources to it. There's another, look how good these tiles are, right? These floodplain tiles. And when you build on top of them, they don't get replaced, right? If I build on top of a marsh, the marsh gets replaced. But if I build on top of a floodplain, it doesn't get replaced. So I can build, like, farms along here. A feudalism, this is generating, like, an incredible amount of food. And I could also get a pantheon called Lady of the Marshes and Reeds and stuff. And that will give all of these tiles +1 production. I think these are all floodplains. Yeah, look, you can see. And so that'll be fucking amazingly powerful, actually. I'm going to head the long way around. Oh, okay, there's even more luxuries here. So if I build it here, that is in range of this banana. It's also in range of this banana and this tea. It's off the coast. I can build a harbour here and hopefully Kabul won't fucking expand to here or here. It might do. I might have to buy up these tiles. Damn it. I hate buying up tiles. We'll see. It's a bit of a long way to go as well. But we're going to do it. Do I want to just move the settler or shall I just leave him a turn and I have an escort? Let's have an escort just for fucking safety procedures. I'm going to build another slinger, and we're going to end our turn.
I'm also interested.
All right. Oh, there's some iron. All right, where else can we build here then? See, because there's no fresh water, it makes it difficult to build a city. I mean, we can do, it just means it will grow more slowly, and we have to be a little bit more careful around housing. It's not the end of the world. To build a city with no fresh water, but it's not something that you should do at all, really. We are going to go with one. We're going to build masonry, I think. And we really want to go. I'll tell you what we want to go for. We really want to get this culture, this civic. Because it's got this thing with 50% production towards settlers and reducing the cost of purchasing tiles. So we can swap in the settlers one, build a couple of settlers, swap it out, for the purchasing tiles, and then buy a couple of tiles, swap it in and out. I think I've already, I mean, this is it's turn 19. I think I've built a settler pretty soon in this game. You know, and I've built it without the focus attached. Oh shit, that's a barbarian. That's fine. We are going to build the granary that we said we'd build. And we're going to rush it and chop it down that forest. There you go, it's built instantly. So that'll solve some of our issues. We are going to build one more slinger. Just for the protection. Settlers won't capture my units. They scouts. They will if they can't move, for example. But usually, they won't like try and see that. See, this is a barbarian attack. I think I just want to move back a tile actually, and I probably want to just. I want to get back towards the city as much as possible. I'll probably run up this way, help cover. Now, our city won't attack because we haven't built ancient walls or anything. We could build ancient walls, but we're not going to. Right, here come all of the bobs. So, This, if I leave this thing here, there's a good chance he's going to die. So what I might do is just sacrifice this rice. They'll move on to the rice and try and pillage it. And I'll just hammer in both the slingers and we'll hope for the best. The defense of this tile is doesn't actually have a penalty. Hill obviously gives it plus defense modifier 6, whatever that means. I think floodplains normally have a negative defense modifier, for example, though. So yeah, -2. I guess that means -2 attack or whatever. So these have like 15. I guess it's mainly around, based around melee. We've got 3 slingers now. We don't really want any more. I think we go another builder here because I love builders. But then again, we might be able to do a quick monument to get that extra culture, because currently we've got 2 culture coming in. This is a second science tree. It uses culture, so we probably want that. Ah, shit, that's not what we want to do at all. We don't need to go the fucking shit way around. All right, he's probably got a promotion. Maybe another promotion. We'll find out. These guys just got to hold these guys up. And so, yeah, this is the old barbarian invasion. It is a thing that happens quite often in this game. I'm going to back these guys off because they're getting owned. See, they've left these slingers here. So I'm going to just sling these guys. Hopefully. It's not quite enough damage. See, I really needed to change this civic over from building slingers to giving them extra damage. If I'd had these, if I'd had the civic equipped, if this was one turn earlier, which unfortunately it's just been slightly mistimed, I would be hitting a lot harder. I'm a little bit concerned now because I think these guys might attack over the river and these guys might sling me. I think this sling might die. I could have swapped them around, but then I wouldn't have been able to attack on this one. I would have been able to still attack on this one because this one's moving off a hill, this one's moving onto a hill. So I would have lost an attack, but maybe I should have done that actually. It's fine. Let's keep these guys moving. I could probably unattach them. Put them on my settler now, on my scout now. So I might do that.
When waste shit. War, that's the positive well, aspect of trade, I suppose.
We lost a settler.
The world
guys.
Gets stirred up together.
We lost a settler. In other news, this warrior is about to die. Oh, shit. But he's dragged that warrior out, so let's just move him back. It's kind of irrelevant. He's not pillaging my stuff, and he's not standing on a tile that I desperately need either, so I'm okay. I'm going to build one more slinger to replace the one that died. I'm going to choose this civic and do half of it, because it's the one I want the most of all. Also, this actually needs grow your civilization to at least 6 pop, right? It's not city. It's an early focus, but man, I'm gonna have to switch my. Do I switch back or not? Probably not. Sorry, I'm thinking about whether I switch my government back. It might be a while before I change this again. I still don't have a pantheon. Fuck. I feel like I've been doing that forever. When's my envoy coming? A million years. This is such a long way away, this city. Oh my god. It's literally like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11 tiles walk. But it's actually only 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. It's the right number-ish. Let's unattach him. This city-state won't steal my settler. And hopefully he'll be alright to make it around to there. Need another city down, really. Greece will probably be looking to put a city here before long. That can't be right. Can't be at 2. Got to be at more than that. Maybe it was at 2 when I got friendly with them. I got the old pyramids, which I'd like to build, but I'm sort of fighting off barbs at the moment. I'm trying to be quite efficient about it. I've got the water mill for mining a resource, even though I didn't mine anything, so I must have gotten that boost from somewhere else. So I might as well research the water mill, because it's the right direction, right? This way gets me the lumber mill eventually, which is nice to have, and crossbows. I'm really looking to unlock the harbour, which needs me to improve 2 sea resources, which is unlikely to happen anytime soon. I need to unlock sailing at some... Ah, shit, I've got to get sailing. Because then my builder can get him his luxury, which I actually do need. I do need a luxury. Alright, fine. Alright. Got 2 slingers. Move one out. Attack. That guy as well. So I ended up not changing my government at all. And if I had done that, thing would have died. Which is probably a better play. This sling is not really needed anymore, so I'm just going to scout with him a little bit. Right, so now we want to build. Oh, I really want to build a settler. I don't have the thing yet. I'm gonna go one more builder, and then we'll cut these things down. God damn! Right, so we'll swap these two around, and then we'll attack. Alright, that's all fine. This guy can just hug here. Hopefully this guy won't pillage that fucking farm. There is a naked barbarian outpost here. I guess good job Toronto for killing it. Thanks for that. And that didn't get me my pantheon, but I can do a pantheon now. For pantheon, we are gonna pick... It's a bit late, so there's probably some of them have probably already gone. Yeah, Desert Folklore's gone, interestingly. God, all these garbage. I'm unlikely to play a faith game due to the fact that I'm not a faithy civ. Fertility rights, city growth rate is always a good one. I think that this is actually, God of War's not as bad as you think, but I'm not going to build holy sites, so it's kind of irrelevant. But 8 tiles. So bonus faith equal to 50% of the strength of enemy units killed within 8 tiles. So 8 tiles is a lot. Right? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So 8 tiles of my capital. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. That's a huge sort of area of the map. You know, if I built a holy site here, and I was attacking all around this city, and maybe this city, maybe a city here, or maybe defending, that would be so much faith, but I'm not playing a faith game. I'm not going to clear any barb outposts. I guess, like, fertility rights is the classic shit pantheon for people who don't care about pantheons. We're just gonna go with it. Cool. Man, the city's taking forever to get down. Still, it'll be good. It'll be good once we get it down. He pillaged it. Motherfucker. shit. I wanna. Fine. Free scout. Thanks. I guess that's okay. I can use it. It's not the worst thing in the universe. Let's go back to the wheel and get a water mill. Oh my god, my settler made it, guys. He made it. And so, there you go, giving me one production. Instantly made this boosted. So one population instantly made this boosted. So now settlers will be a lot cheaper. So he's on the run now. Jerk. So I want to get started on this settler, really. Yeah, I'll get started on the settler. See, this is the problem now. Look, I've now minus one amenities and minus 5 out of 6 housing capacity. Now, that means that I'm not only population growth slowed, but I'm minus citizen growth and 5% production, science, everything's like down. So this is why I need to get this hooked up, which I will do next turn. So I'm doing okay. At this city, I really want probably to buy a tile. Because this tile is like so good. I don't want to really buy too many tiles without having that cheap tile thing. So I'll just buy that tile for now, and then I'll buy some more once I've got the cheap tile improvement things. I could get a trader. It's expensive. I think I should get a builder out here, because even though I'm not getting a speed bonus for building builders, I think it's just the right thing to do. Yeah, early empire. Looking forward to that. Right, let's go and get it.
It was luxuries like air conditioning.
So we've got the pantheon. We can finally get rid of this. We are going to slap in production for the settlers, and we're going to get rid of this as well and put it on barb fighting, because we're not going to build any more units for now. We are going to promote this slinger. I'm going to attack these with our scout, because we can harass them down. Going to get that luxury. We are going to go over here and probably hopefully chase this scout down, or else this fucking Leeds is going to get attacked. We're going to just see if we can scout some more. This area looks like fairly clean and empty of other players. There's that city on the river. See, could have been there. Just think about how nice it would be to be there. I think what we're going to do is we'll go on this river instead. We're just going to go here, and that will kind of act like a kind of a better border. Maybe we can get some ships and go and fuck him up later. This is a lake, which is interesting. We could settle on the lake. I think lake gives fresh water, so maybe a city like here. But I think I'd like to get another city around Kilimanjaro, because these yields are so good. So I'll be buying up these tiles pretty soon. And then another city around here. Maybe there's another river system. And then maybe I can take Toronto, because these tiles are too good for them. Lots of places. Lots of space. So we're in a pretty nice place. I almost like to play, though, as if I was playing against another player, right? So I'm glad that he has settled there, because that's what a player would do. It feels like this is Japan here, okay? So they should be settling here, right? Which means that because I'm settling here, I probably can settle here too. So that's 1, 2. It feels like there'd be another player, or this would be the end of the continent, maybe. I don't know. It's because we don't have multiplayer yet. I want to try and... I don't want to play a game where I basically just end up building way more cities than I would do in multiplayer, because then it's not sort of realistic for my plan, or like the way I'd play. Yeah. We're just going to... Actually, I want to get the government, actually, so... This wants me to build a district. I really want to get this government, because it's a lot better than what I'm using at the moment. But building a district is very unlikely, seeing as I haven't actually even bothered to get any of them yet. So I'm not going to build a district yet. So I'm just going to have to hard grind through that. But that's fine. That's how we're going to do it. This guy wants to get shot, which is cool. And so we're just basically prepping for our first settle to go out. And I don't actually even know what's here. Let's go and have a look. A barbarian. See, this is not a great place to settle. This doesn't even count as a river, even though it's at this apex. So if we wanted to settle on this hill, which obviously has an advantage, but it doesn't have that much of an advantage like settling on hills. This is settled on hills, but it doesn't have two production, it only has one. So settling on hills only has a defensive advantage, which is not bad for a city that is sticking out here. But the problem is this city won't have fresh water, so I'd have to build an aqueduct here or here or here or here. I could settle it here. This is a desert hill again. I could settle it here. That's on technically on fresh water. That doesn't look the worst, but these desert tiles are garbage. Desert tiles are particularly bad. They're not as bad as they used to be in the game because you can build shit on them and it doesn't matter. Like if I'm going to build a pyramids on here or a campus or a fucking theatre district or aqueducts or any of this shit on here, it doesn't matter that it's a terrible tile because it kind of isn't going to be worked anyway, so it's not producing its yield. But this many dead tiles is a bit of a problem. Yeah, we'll see. I mean, it doesn't matter particularly. I think having more cities is a little bit of a problem because it increases the cost of all of your districts and stuff. So it's not something you really want to have too much of. We are just about hanging on with housing in London, despite the fact that we don't have fresh water. We need to repair this fucking thing. And send that guy scouting. This will speed up a lot once I've got some popping in. The wheels. Scythia. Honestly, a bit annoyed they're in the game, because I'm not annoyed they're in the game, but I've never heard of them. And that's okay. That's all right. But it's just a little bit annoying. There's a lot of people they could have put in. But they're in. And that's fine. Maybe it's fine. Maybe I shouldn't be, like, angry about a civ that I've never heard of being in a game. Maybe I should just do some research on them. Maybe I'll find they're actually really interesting. I might do that. I'll do that for next time, and then I'm sure I'll be great with it. Let's quickly do some donations. Kovalaki says, did you get my cheese whiz, boy? I think we did, yeah. Thanks for that. I can't remember getting it, but I think it's upstairs. Melian the Maya has resubbed, and Graham Uel. Thank you. Graham Uel. Hopeless Q, thank you for subscribing. Lone Warrior has subscribed. Bowler Much has subscribed. Draven has resubbed. Happy birthday, Lewis. A bit premature, but that's how I roll. It is the date. Yeah, it's about a week early. That's very early. If you came like a week early, she would be like, whoa. James JB has resubbed. Thank you. Sputnik Writer has also resubbed. Cheers to you. Base Dyer is a new subscriber. Thank you. Romanian Factor is a new subscriber. There you go. Random people are subscribing. We now get subscriber notifications. That's cool. Thanks, Sam. I've read those two. We're good. We're up to date. So, yeah. I'm here playing Civ. If you want to ask me questions or otherwise, let me know. I can't move. Alright, we'll take out this camp without beastly army of doom. I could have gotten a quick upgrade to archery, which wouldn't have been the worst thing. So yeah, let's look at this settler. So yeah, these green tiles are all tiles with fresh water. These ones are obviously, this river system is way better. But there is a barb camp there. Ugh, what a ball ache. Where do I settle here? I want to kind of settle here. If I settled here, then I could do another settle. Maybe along here somewhere. I'm already on the ocean anyway, so it's not the worst thing in the universe. This is really interesting because I could build a harbour here. And obviously there would be a harbour here from London already. So I'd have two harbours right next to each other. If I built a commercial centre here, which I actually can't do because there's a strategic resource there. But if I could, it would get two gold from here and two gold from each other's harbour. So it would be like 6 gold per turn. And then if I got the boost, I could get up to 12 gold per turn. Which doesn't actually sound very much now I say it. 12 gold per turn. Who cares? So maybe I won't do that. I'm just thinking in terms of like stacking cities together. Sometimes it's good to build all of your districts from 2 or 3 cities in the same area between them. You end up with this big mega city, okay, like this big triangle of city here, and then a load of farms and stuff around the outside. And that's okay because they all get bonuses. Almost all the districts get a bonus if they're adjacent to 2 other districts. So if you've got an area of shitty land, like maybe this desert, for example, is really shit. If you've got a city here, you can just stack this desert full of districts and it'll actually be great. It almost like replace the desert and it's like a really, really, really good place. So that's the thing. Also, obviously, be settling on desert deletes one tile. The other option is, of course, building Petra. Getting Petra in my 3rd city seems optimistic. It is doable, but it's certainly optimistic due to the fact that there's not really that much production. There's 6 production tiles here, and I could cut them all down. I could just go slap a city down, chop, 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 build the Petra, hope for the best. But that seems bad as well. I mean, if there was a lot of mining resources or desert hills or something like that here, it might be different. These aren't desert hills. These are plains hills. I don't really like plains tiles. They're a bit sort of shit. Well, I mean, they're good because they have a production instead of a food, but it's just if you start on a plains area, it's a very slow start. To get pop it is. Where am I going to settle this? I think I'm going to go here. It is going to overlap a little bit, but only with like this crappy tile, which doesn't count, which I was going to build the pyramids on. This tile, which is good, but doesn't really matter. Overlaps here, overlaps a little bit. That's okay. It's not the worst. You have to be a little bit careful because when you have these cities in Civ 6, all the districts tend to add up and suddenly you don't have any workable tiles anymore. So your cities are a lot smaller as a result, usually. I feel like they need to have like a dedicated district for farming or something like that. That might be an interesting thing to do, but maybe that's something for like a future tech. Yeah, this game, I don't know. It feels good at the moment though. Let's build a trader. We're going to plonk this guy down and then trade to him. I want to go here now. Maybe that's too far. Is that too greedy? Okay, yeah, I've changed my mind. I just want to see how it works. I'm still experimenting. It's all about having fun. Let's heal this guy. Oh, right, this is another end of the world. Weird. I'm pretty sure this is a Pangaea. I did want to buy up these tiles, but I'll do that once I've finished building settlers. Let's build another settler. Worker. See, this is the one to build wonders. So maybe I'll go with the pyramids after this settler. So that'll be four cities, pyramids. Optimistic? Do you think I'll get it? Would I get it in a multiplayer game? Maybe. I don't like to. I don't want to buy any tiles because it's so expensive. This is kind of crap. Maybe I'll just save the charge.
Thousands have lived without love.
Hanging Gardens. I wonder if I can build that anywhere. I can build it here, I guess. Hanging Gardens. Oh, no, it's not hills. It has to be on flatland next to the river, so I can't build it. I can build it here. I don't think I want to do that, though. Might be okay. I don't know how far. What turn is it? Turn 33. I'm not that far down the tech tree, although I have got these three already. I'm not really too worried about science, in fact. I mean, science, if you're efficient with the boosts, right, and you build a bit of everything, you can make up a little bit for having slightly poor science. Especially if you can get to things a little bit earlier than normal. I'm not going to build a holy site. I'm not going to get a religion. It's just unrealistic to think that that's a good idea. That means my pantheon will eventually be gobbled up by someone else's religion, but fertility rights, who cares? Who is that? Is that actually Victoria? Jesus, well, why is she wearing like a French blue sash for a start? Why is she looking so grumpy? She doesn't look anything like Victoria. Is that a painting? Is that of Assassin's Creed? Is she a member of the fucking Assassins? Steve, Jesus Christ. You see, I seem lonely. Thanks, Steve. Appreciate it. It's nice that you're thinking about my loneliness. Wasn't actually lonely before you said anything. We're gonna just. Ugh, we're gonna march across this river. Alright. Maybe we should have upgraded these guys. We'll find out if it bites in the ass later. I sometimes am a little bit. It's tricky to make these decisions. I think we are gonna need writing eventually, so let's get that going. That's all fine. Man, there is no other AIs on this land. This is one of the things about the world generation at the moment. It just feels like the lands aren't really very filled out, so you have so much space. I'm going to back off a bit and heal. I'm going to move this guy in. I don't think they can walk over those hills, which is fine. This guy is going to remove this rainforest at some point. It gives us 19 production. We are currently 40 away from this settler. So, but I think because we get bonus production, I don't think this production will go towards it properly. Maybe it will. Maybe what I'll do is I'll build this settler manually. See, I'm at half on this state workforce. That's five turns. If I'm going to build a district in the next whatever amount of time, do I want to just not do this? I hate building something without a boost. But then again, what else do I get? Like, great signing points, great profits, they don't matter, especially because I can't put them in anything without this government. Productions are... I don't want any of that crap either. I kind of want this. But that needs me to get construction. Right, fine. I'm just going to carry on doing it. Hard building it. We're doing it. It's a choice. We've made it. I'm just going to sleep this guy. Until we want to... Oh, God. What's all the way? God, there's just nothing up here, is there? This is a whole area for us to colonize if we choose.
Writing is
holy...
Easy.
How many barbs there are? Oh, Hopefully we can hold them off here. We can actually move this guy up and promote him into an archer. Let's get an archer researched. That's actually going to be really fucking useful for us. We should probably bring the slinger back at some point. He's fucking finding tribal villages at like turn 35. Oh, yeah, great. Manchester. Build that. I'm guessing we want to build. Well, look, we don't want a campus again because there's no rainforest or mountain. A campus here is garbage. These guys could, this could build a campus decently here. We can still cut down that rainforest and still have a decent. Oh no, we can build a campus here. This is great. So this is a great. Is that forest or rainforest? Shit, that's not rainforest. So campus gets +1 for 2 rainforest. Right, so it has to have 2 rainforest and +1 per mountain. So if we build one here, this will be okay. So what we'll do is we'll have a campus here. Then what we'll do is we'll build our harbour here and our commercial site here. Then that means it'll get 1, 2, 3 science. And that'll be a decent campus. And it's in our second city. And this is a decent city. I need to switch the civics out fairly soon so I can get buy tiles and I can buy up all these tiles fairly cheap so the city state doesn't grab them all. This is a fairly crappy tile otherwise. Once this builder comes out, I'll improve the silk, I think, because I think amenities apply to the first 4 cities. And we could do with another one in London, like, if it keeps growing. But that settler's going to come out soon. And we're going to send the settler up here, hopefully. This fucking guy is probably going to die. That's fine. 75 big ones. Can't complain. I feel like we should build another fucking slinger here just because to deal with all these barbarians. That'll start turning into an archer anyway as soon as we get this, so slingers just get replaced. Jesus, he almost died. So we can retreat him 2 tiles and promote. He's not going to die this turn, which is nice. I'm going to leave this slinger here. I'm going to also leave that slinger there. I'm going to finish off this guy. I don't think this warrior is going to get attacked. This is how we're doing it. We're grouping up. We're working together. We're working as a team. Cool. What time is it? I've been an hour. Okay, I need to get a move on, otherwise I'm never close to
I shot an arrow into the...
Wow, so the spearman did suicide onto my slinger. Amazing. Shit, that was actually a hill. That's not good, is it? This guy might die. God, so many. He's probably going to move and sling me. Alright, we might lose some units here. I just want to get a city down. I'm a bit scared to do so. I didn't even scout this. This is a horrible place for a city, though. We're going to just... move this guy out here. We can move him to here next turn, and then across the river, then we can decide to go north or south. Depending on how bad the situation looks. But currently, doesn't look great. We're never going to get that. We do need to get harbour at some point, though. To improve... Alright, let's get astrology. It's one turn. Away. We'll build a builder and chop this. That looks bad. Let's heal up. I don't think you can walk across the marsh. Water mill, we don't have one of them. We do need to get one for a boost. But I think I'm going to get building this campus.
A strong economy begins.
Right, fantastic. We're not building any settlers. We are going to build a wonder, but probably not immediately. We are going to buy some tiles, so let's do that cheaper than normal. Right. So we know we want to buy up probably this tile. We could go this tile into this tile. That's where we're going to build the pyramids, guys. We're going to go for this one because that's the good one. Well, he's almost at the end of the continent, so we can send him home. Oh, he's at the end of the turn.
I don't believe in astrology.
I lost a warrior and a slinger to barbarians. Jesus Christ. It's nuts, isn't it? It's crazy. Let's... Can I still shoot for moving back? Going the other way, guys. Going the other way. This guy's still got a use, I didn't realise. Guess we could improve those bananas. I was going to chop down some of this rainforest too. I guess we wait. Let's get an archer. Man, we are getting absolutely owned by barbarians. Look at this. We have played it either really poorly or they are just kicking my ass. We will improve that sea resource. So let's get towards this, and then we can get a harbour on the go. We are going to buy up this tile and this tile. That's what we wanted, right? So that's the harbour plus the commercial district. Might need this one. I don't think they're going to grab it. I don't think I really urgently need it, but it's cheap. So now I've got the buff, let's do it. Oh yeah, and we want this tile because it's like a fucking awesome tile. Oh shit, and we want that one as well, eventually. Slapping it down there. This builder...
I'm no good at staying
straight.
I
suppose I could send him around here. There's... Slinger. There's a barb camp on that island, that's fine. Pericles is like mocking us now. He's like, you guys suck. Oh, my scout was killed as well. Can't believe it. I'm losing everyone. It's all going wrong. The misplays, the hugest, the biggest misplays. We're going to go and settle around here, I think. We're going to settle like these fucking deserts, man. And we're going to settle here. I'm relating to that iron. It's more desert. Man. The city's gonna be like just gimped by desert massively. I suppose I can chop these trees down. More riskily captured by a bloody barbarian coming out this way. We have lost like almost our entire army. Yeah. I should have probably upgraded my slingers to archers sooner. Okay, that's something for next time. Because look how much better they are, look. Ugh. Look how much better that is instantly. Slingers are just fucking trash. Production. From just chopping a fucking wood down that is two tiles out of my capital's range. Bam. That's half the pyramids done in one turn. Without the 15% bonus. Feels good. Feels good, man. I've probably got to chop this one down as well. Screw the rainforests. Who needs them? Not me, that's for goddamn sure. We're going to go to this banana. Oh, we've got a slinger. Where's our slinger? Oh, this one. Yeah, I think we're going to make our way super slowly back home. Don't know what I was doing with this slinger, really. Let's bring him back to friendly territory. The settler is just completely naked. I can't believe I'm sending this out. He's still alive. He's not dead. Maybe all the barbarians are focused on this side. I don't have to worry about... Look at these fucking archers. They're so, so much better. They're like 100 times better. Build a plantation. Scythia sending me a trelegation. Where is she based? I wonder what all these city state quests are, actually. These guys want me to send a trade route. We haven't still done a trade route. These guys want a campus. We're doing that. We're doing that, Geneva. These guys want an encampment. We are not doing that. These guys want a spearman. We could do that. That doesn't seem unreasonable. Liverpool. London leads Liverpool. Cool. What's the... All the else. Yeah, difficult to know what to do here. It's not the worst. We'll need a granary eventually. It is going to grow decently. Let's make sure these guys are on food production. Alright, fine. Go up here. How much do we need? How much does this give? 24 food and 24 production. Alright, well, fuck the rainforest, guys. I hope none of you were attached to any of it, because London... Honestly, do you see any rainforest in England? I don't. That's because we cut them all down in the classical era to build the pyramids.
Divide and rule, a sound.
That's what happened. Fact. 10% bonus on wonder production. Yeah, that feels like a little bit late, doesn't it? But I'll go with it. Maybe if we'd been slightly better in our timing, we would have got this sooner. Maybe not, though. We're going to get... good. Plus 15% towards classical wonder production. Feels bad. Builders, I think. And probably production... We're not going to... We want to build any more settlers? Do we want to build any more settlers? Yeah, we kind of want settler here. If we were playing this in a multiplayer game and we actually wanted to win, we would settle here, 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 we would settle... Fucking... We would settle everywhere. But I feel like in a multiplayer game against good opponents on the right size map, that wouldn't be an option, right? So I feel like I shouldn't be settling here because Japan should settle here. And so I'm kind of just like, I want to get a real idea of what a real competitive game is, because this is so easy, this difficulty setting. There's no challenge at all. You know, we're at turn 43 on quick. It is quick though, so bear that in mind. We're going to get the pyramids. We've got four cities. This city's doing pretty well. We are still fighting the barbs, but, you know, c'est la vie. If I didn't have enough land, because normally, like, you normally in Civ game that we play, you get just about enough land for four cities, and then you have to think, or even three cities, you think, oh, shit, do I have to kill a city-state, you know, in order to get enough land for a fourth city? Whereas this is much, much different. And it makes for a different sort of play style, really. And it also makes for a much, much longer play style. That if you're going to play, like, three or four cities, it's a fairly, like, reasonable amount to keep, like, control of and organize. Whereas if you're up to, like, seven or eight, it's suddenly a lot more complicated. And if everyone's running 7 or 8 cities, you know, and you've got like 2 minutes to take your turn, that's a lot of like faffing around to do. So I'm not quite sure how multiplayer's gonna feel in Civ 6. I think we have to see what meta, because we have sort of established, I mean, the No Quitters mod, for example, is a meta, right? They've got their map pack, it's a specific size, it's taken a long time for them to hone it down. This to me just feels like, oh, like Lebensraum. Do you know, so much Lebensraum. Maybe that's okay, but it'll take me a long time. I'm going to win the game. I don't think I need all this land to win the game. Maybe I do. I don't know. I'm just waffling now. I didn't actually confirm this because I'm an idiot. So let's think about that. Production, builders, and unit maintenance reduced. I don't think I want to build any more archers to avoid it, although I am already building one. Here's pyramids.
From the height of these pyramids, 40 centuries.
Free builder. All builders build 4 times. That's good, man. And it is good because, honestly, like 4 times, big deal. It's a big fucking deal. I could probably even get Hanging Gardens as well. That seems really cheeky. I would never get both of them in a multiplayer game, so let's not do it. I mean, in a way, like, I don't mind getting a few things like Ancient Walls because it does unlock a tech. So if you think about it like that, you know, think about it like this. This is Aqueduct. This is quite a thing. This is a district I actually do want. It's 134 science. So building an Ancient Wall somewhere is worth 70, well, you know, 60, 68, 67 science is it's worth. Which is not the worst. Shit, I fucked this up. I wasn't paying attention. I didn't improve my sea wonder. My sea thing. Lost a bit of science there for not boosting that. Oh, that's what happens. We're going to wait a turn. And we're going to build. We're going to build a trader. Ah, shit. Let's just get rid of that rainforest and be done a turn. This other worker probably wants a bit more housing in London, so let's get these areas all farmed up. That'll give us extra housing. Cool. My archer's going to hunt down some guys who've been harassing me. Worker's going to... Scout's going to scout.
Set your course by the stars. Bravery right. Is being the only one.
Okay. I can change it again. I'm not going to. Let's go for drum poetry. Yeah, that's probably what I want. I'm not going to get... Man, this would be fun to build. Maybe I should try and build that. So... If I build another, let's get this trade route going. Probably to Leeds, I would guess. It's going around the roads, I guess of course it is. Looks like sea trade routes don't really give that much more of a bonus. Who wanted a trade route from me? Was it this guy? Yeah. That does give no production. I mean, the nice thing about these trade routes is they just give a production boost and a food. Whereas this does give an envoy. But this envoy is probably pointless, right? The Jerusalem envoy will give me +2 faith in the capital, which I give no shits about whatsoever. So we're just going to send it to Leeds and get a road going around this way, just in case. Because this is really out the way. If this was multiplayer and there was like people here, getting troops to defend this city would be an absolute ball ache. I mean, it is relatively... isolated, like it's difficult to get through this choke point, but it's not super safe, so I might be scared about that. Hooray, my Royal Navy dockyard. Let's build it here. Cool. I'm gonna chop down these 2 forests to build it. Wow, it's gonna be done in 3 turns anyway. That's pretty quick. And I want that commercial district. Ah, that's good. I'm researching currency. Okay. Cool. We're all going. Everything's going good. A jungle. Shall we chop? We could chop the jungle. Does this actually get the extra? Where did that come from? I just got a thing for construction. Didn't I? What did I just get? What was that I just got? I thought it said construction. I thought I'd built a water mill. I boosted something. I'm not sure what I boosted. What did I boost, guys? I have no idea. Because nothing appears to be boosted. So, maybe I didn't boost anything. In Manchester, we're going to build some ancient walls, probably. Seeing as this is like my stick-out city. I need him for the science thing. Two turns left. It's pretty cheap, this dockyard. I didn't realise how cheap it was. How much is the settler? 80. If we build a settler and chop it out, I'll be done in no time. Let's go back to that for a turn. Okay. Two turns still campus. How much is that a build? 16. Alright, let's sort to a water mill. Chop this down. And switch back to the campus. Alright. Let's put these guys on auto now. And leave them to it. I think they've pretty much done the whole island, so they'll go back over here and do that. I don't have to do it, I don't really want to do that manually. This builder's gonna chop as well, which gives me another 50 production. Holy shit. So much production. What do I want to build with it? Another builder. That will actually do it in one turn. Let's do that. And then we'll get another dockyard. So this builder can go and build this farm. All right. These builders, chopping to build more builders, is just pretty. I mean, I'm gonna run out of forests now here.
The poets have been mysterious.
But man, look how valuable that was. It's just nuts. So the reason I've cut that forest down was because I could, because I'm gonna build a commercial district on it now. You know, plus 5 because it's next to the Navy dockyard, and I guess my and a river. That seems like a lot, doesn't it? I guess it's plus 2 for the river, plus 2 for the harbour, and plus 1 for being next to 2 districts, so plus 5. See, that's great. I could always consider lifting this rice up, put an aqueduct there, which actually I probably will do. And then here I can put another district, and then that'll be up to plus 6. Maybe I won't. Maybe plus 5 is fine. Maybe I won't min-max that much now. Maybe I'll keep the rice in this nice farm setup. Let's go. Let's do that. Shoot you. I need to clear out this camp, really, and get a settler over there. That's what I probably should be doing with these archers, not fucking milling around down here. Petra? I can actually try and build Petra. That sounds crazy, but maybe if I chop all these trees down, I'll be able to build Petra before anyone else does. We also probably want to do. This is an option. So this is a cool. This is a cool wonder, the Colosseum, right? If you build an entertainment complex, so this is the thing I was talking about with the triangular of cities, right? So if I had a city here, and then I built like an entertainment complex in the middle, and then I build the Colosseum, it extends its bonus to all of the cities within 6 tiles. So if I built it here, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, so it will go like a good way around. So any cities I build in this range, so if I built a city here and here, and I build this entertainment city here, it will apply to all these different cities, which is like OP. But obviously it's a wonder, so it will get snapped up. But it's a fairly late one. You have to boost it. You have to get construction, which I don't have yet. Even though my science is pretty solid, let's have a look at what my score is like compared to the other cities. Not that this matters at all. I am like far ahead of everyone else, but technologically, I'm also far ahead of everyone else, despite the fact that I haven't even built a campus. That's not to say that this would be the case in multiplayer. In multiplayer, I'm sure other people would have if this was my first city, right, and I founded this straight away, I'd think, damn, let's get this campus down early, you know, because there's a good place for it. With here, no mountain. There was a couple of rainforests, but fuck them, they weren't really worth it. I'm not gonna build a campus with plus one science on it. Like, what's the point? I might as well just build stuff that I know is gonna be good and give me a lot of gold or other stuff. I feel like this dockyard will give me gold. Also, if I build a shipyard at the dockyard, it gives me more for the adjacency bonus. So basically, like, this gives you an adjacency bonus so plus one for each coastal resource, plus one for each two adjacent districts. So it'll only be getting plus two. I suppose that's not great. But then if I build a shipyard in there, it gives me bonus production equal to the adjacency bonus. So it will give me another plus two. Which is not the worst. The other thing is, like, encampments are not terrible because they do give you, when you build a barracks and when you build these things, some production. Also, building an encampment is actually relevant towards some of these civics that I see this one, build an encampment. So I probably ought to build one at some point. I feel like I'm not boosted any of these, so it's going to be even slower for my culture gain. This will be done in one turn. Well, let's just get on with it. Halfway through a watermill here, so let's just finish that off. Oh, my slinger's nearly back. Mysticism from his fucking journey around the bloody world. I've still got production tools, builders instead of anything else, but I think that's okay. I don't really want to switch back to tile purchasing yet, so we're going to carry on and might build a couple more builders. See how it goes. This city is not growing at all, so we might want to buy up a tile, which doesn't suck. So it's all going well. Let's go through some donations. Erstradamus, 11 months, resub. Thank you. Jarkal the Burninator. Hey, Lulu, what are your opinions on the lack of the World Congress at Civ 6's launch? Also, can you rename Civs yet? I don't think you can rename Civs. I think I could rename... Can I rename... Do you mean cities? I don't think you can, you know. I tried this earlier. Like, you can't. The way they're named, okay, is apparently the way it works is... they have, like in Civ... Five, they have a list of possible city names, and there's like 50 or whatever for each civ. And the first one you settle is always going to be, in the case of England, London. But then the next city is picked randomly out of the next 10 on the list with an algorithm that slightly declines as it goes down, right? So it's most likely to pick the second one on the list, but it's less and less likely as it goes down. So normally, for example, like before, I think Manchester was one of my first cities, but then the second one I picked was Bristol, whereas this time I got Leeds, then Manchester, then Liverpool. So it's randomised, but you could just keep missing Leeds over and over again, but you might hit like a really small one, like, I don't know, Halifax or some small shithole, like Cardiff. I'm not sure Cardiff's allowed. Can't rename civs. Can rename units after they've got level 2, but none of our units have level 2, because we could let them all die like a fucking idiot. Reds fan, thank you. Thank you to Hisso222 for subscribing. Some kind of fucking asshole. Hey, Lewis. You got me hooked on Dream Quest after you played it on livestream a while ago, so I thought I'd recommend a cool game to you that I found. It's called Pathos NetHack Codex. I will look it up. I am always looking for shitty iOS games to play. I don't play many iOS games, but... Dream Quest is one of the ones which I quite liked. I bought it for it was really cheap, and or even possibly free back when I got it. And I've got a lot of hours out of it. and I enjoyed it. It's okay to have a guilty pleasure occasionally, but man, some iOS games, when they get their hooks into you, are like horrible, abusive games. Don't go down that way. It's bad for you. Navatia, hey Lewis, just wanted to say it's been wonderful following you in the Oscars for 6 years. Thanks for making people laugh throughout so many years. Keep up the amazing work. Dave Ognall. Thank you, Navasia. That's a lovely, lovely donation message. Daniel SB, 6 month resub. Gazar 831, did you and Duncan ever figure out if there was a happiness penalty to settle a bunch of cities? There isn't a happiness penalty, actually, but each luxury resource only applies to, I think, the nearest 4 cities that don't have it yet. So if I had 2 whales here, they would apply out to the nearest 8 cities, or the first whale would apply to the first 4, and then the next one would apply out to the next 4. So each luxury doesn't apply to your whole civ. Also, the more cities you have, the more expensive districts get, and the more districts you have, I think the more expensive they get too. So I think that is the balancing factor. I believe there may be something else too, but you will have to ask Bretor on the Reddit, seeing as he is the knowledgeable one about nerdy shit like that. But as far as I'm concerned, just having lots of cities seems to be fine. ZRXX Master has subscribed. Thank you. Chaz and Dave has subscribed. Thank you. And West Manovich has resubbed, celebrating 5 months with my favourite Yogg and my favourite game franchise. Yeah, it's good, isn't it, Civ? It's really good. It's a real game. It's a hell of a game. It's a hell of a drug. Man, I do like the pyramids. They are cool. I'm glad we managed to build them. I don't think it's too late to build them either. We are going to go for Geneva without Envoy and get that bonus for this campus, which I believe will boost 21 science per turn, which is actually pretty solid. Pretty solid at this point of the game. We are going to move up and shoot. We're going to move up. We're going to go and clear this barb camp, and we're going to go and send our dude up there. We're going to keep building housing here at this city to try and get away from that encroaching housing capacity. Because if we can get away from it, we'll get more people, and that's what we want. These guys are obviously hit the housing limit, so we probably need to build a granary here. Yeah, we don't have one yet. But that's fine, that'll be done soon. Maybe I'll smash out a builder actually first, and then get granary next. These guys are still slowly chugging out the ancient walls. They'll be done when we need them for the tech. And housing. And walking. Alright, let's get on with it. 50 turns. Man, it's taken a long time. Like, 50 turns is... I'm not sure what Victoria is doing there, but... maybe Steve will let me know.
If I were again beginning my study.
That's Petra. Okay. So. Sixty-four turns. That sounds thoroughly unreasonable. But it would make this city not shit. Is that what Petra looks like? Oh. I guess it hasn't been built yet, but it starts like that. That looks fucking trash, doesn't it? Right, we'll send our workers down and chop all these trees down. We'll send you to here. And you to here. And then hopefully with those 3 trees getting chopped down, that'll finish Petra off before anyone else gets it. Fingers crossed, since we just researched it and we went there pretty quick too. We went to Petra pretty fast, so we have beelined Petra more so than other civs might have done. So in a multiplayer game, we might lose it to someone who started on a desert, but then again, it's only good if you have a lot of desert. And if you've got a lot of desert, then you might want to consider doing a different build at the start. So if I had a lot of desert at the start, I probably would have gone desert folklore, which would have involved building a holy site in that desert. Which is a thing to do. Blah, blah, blah. Okay, sorry, I'm just thinking about where I want to go. We're going to carry on going up here to try and kill this fucking asshole. I still have some guys who are going to End of the turn. Right. So yeah, we're an hour and 40 minutes in. Now, we would aim to do 100 turns in 3 hours. So that is roughly on time. So I'm actually at the moment not playing too far behind. Obviously, some turns have taken longer. Some turns have taken short. I've read some donations and stuff like this. So maybe I'm doing all right. I am suzerain of Geneva. So you'll see 15% sites whenever you are not at war with another nation, which is pretty good, actually. We also gain ownership of cattle and stone, which is kind of irrelevant because they are bonus resources and they don't actually give us a luxury, so that's kind of irrelevant. Why does it say carbol at the bottom there? That's weird. Oh, I guess because it's all combining it all together. Do we want to get 1-2 faith per turn? Not really. Do we want to get 2 production in industrial zone? Not really. Do we want to get 2 production in every encampment? Not really. Just stick another envoy in there. We could have saved. Probably should have saved that envoy in case we bumped into another city-state. Okay, should have done that. Rather than wasting it in that. But it doesn't matter. I tell you what I should be building, really. Not this shit. I should be building a satellite, but...
No hour of life is waste.
I don't really want to try hard too hard. I want to build some fun stuff. Lighthouse. Problem is, Lighthouse doesn't actually seem to improve... Lighthouse used to improve ocean tiles to make them not garbage. But it doesn't seem to do that anymore. Either I'm reading it wrong or the tooltip is wrong. But it says, look, +1 food, +1 gold. So what, just +1 food and +1 gold and +1 housing? Like, what is the point of that? A citizen slot. What does the citizen slot give? I don't know. Is there another thing, the building that you build in the harbour? I thought it was like the shipyard. I mean, this is kind of the end of a dead-end chain anyway, right? So if you're not going to build... If you're in the middle of the world, you don't need to build this. Much like if you're not being attacked in the early game, you don't need to build this. But having 3 archers boosts machinery, which is a big fucking expensive tech. So 90 science, you know, might as well do it. Having 2 harbours boosts this cartography. So again, that saves you 160 science. So... You know, it is worth, and I will have 2 harbours, so it's worth it. Am I going to build 2 galleys? No. So, might as well research that. Sure, but do I want it? No. Industrial zone, this is obviously relevant. Nice if I actually had some fucking mines, but, like, it feels like in this game, mining resources are so rare. I mean, I can build 1 iron mine here. On the entire rest of this continent, we have... No mines at all. In fact, are there any mines that I can see on the entire world? Copper. All right, there's 1 mine there and 2 up here on Geneva. I mean, it wants me to build 3 mines to unlock that. That's just very unreasonable. And also, these obviously need to be built. These industrial zones need to be built near some mines or quarries. Now, you can just build them near other districts, and that will help too. And this is a really important one, because production is really important. I can build it here, which gives it +2, which actually is totally worth doing. I don't think I've done like anything wrong by not beelining for it. I mean, you have to get currency, and you have to get writing. You kind of have to get these things before you can build it anyway. I've beelined to it as best I can. Going here, terracotta army, siege tank, who cares? Siege tank, siege tower, who cares? Aqueduct, like, sure, that's actually useful, but currently I'm still building farms and builders and building and stuff. I can get my aqueducts for a free +2 housing, but like, it's a district, so it does kill one of your tiles, so you don't have to build them. It's obviously important if you've got a city like this, but unfortunately this one hasn't got fresh water, so it's garbage. This has got fresh water, this doesn't have fresh water. But I seem to be fine, just about keeping up with enough. If I build another builder, I was going to finish off the settler. I'll finish off the settler. We'll go and hook up this fish resource, and we'll actually go ahead and build. I really like these naval dockyards, and they're cheap. Look at that, 30 production for plus two food for plus two gold. It seems like really cheap, doesn't it? We do want to settle somewhere else around this thing. This doesn't count. Oh, it does count as a mountain. So you can build a district. So basically, you can build an aqueduct. So if I built a city here, for example, where it didn't have fresh water, I could still build an aqueduct here. I wouldn't get this lovely four food tile, but at least I'd get fresh water in this city, which would mean that it wouldn't really be a ball ache to actually get population in there. There are ways for me later in the game to handle the housing issue, mainly through the very late game, it feels like, neighborhoods, which are miles fucking down here. See, look how far away they are. So these are the districts that give you housing, but they're so far away. I feel like this needs to be moved, because, you know, does it really need to be that far away, especially down the culture tree? I mean, look how far it is. I'm not gonna have it until, like, fucking basically I've won the game. I mean, usually by the time my culture gets this far down, I've won the game. It's even boosting its grower CC to 15 pop, which is pretty hard to do without neighborhoods. You know, this city, if I built an aqueduct there, we give it two more housing, give it to 12. If I farm, you can build farms on hills later, farm, all over the fucking place, farm, I'll probably get up to like 14 or 15 housing capacity. So it might just about get to 15 pop. But yeah, I don't know. I don't know how I feel about it. I'd like to use housing more, because I think they look really cool and they're really interesting, but they're so far away that you just almost never build them. I don't think I've ever built one, because it just is so fucking awkward. Liverpool. Build them. Right, we're shutting this barbarian camp down finally. Oh my god, a goody hut with a fucking builder in it. That's OP as hell. I think I want to start leaving forests alive now, because I can start making lumber mills in them soon, which don't suck. Where was construction? I should have got construction instead of this. Because then I would have boosted this, and I could have changed out. I'm starting to, like, lose my concentration. But this is one of the things, like, it's quite annoying, because if I was playing this optimally, I'd love to just research everything to half, and then, because I'm not going to build an entertainment complex yet, I don't need one. But I'd like to research to half, and then if I get the boost, it'll be done. But because it doesn't stop when you're not paying attention, it's one of those extra things, like, that's making me not. It's almost like a thing, like, sometimes when you play a game, you have to think. It's like when you start a new turn of Hearthstone, I always think, can I get lethal, right? This turn. Is there a way I can get lethal? And that's a really, like, good thing to do, because sometimes you're like, oh, fuck yes, actually, if I do this and this and this, then it's a really shitty play, but it gets me lethal. That's the sort of same thing with this. I have to think every turn, am I going to... what am I going for on this anyway? So, I mean, ugh. So this is a really interesting thing as well, right? Here's Great Library. Great Library. Now, Great Library gives you boosts to all ancient and classical era technologies, right? So it boosts all of classical and ancient. You're like, wow, that means I don't have to think. I could just boost everything. Except, I have researched almost everything in these eras already. I've already boosted this, which I should have researched, to be fair. So imagine I've already researched that. And I start building Great Library now. It's only going to boost engineering, which I know I'm already boosting with ancient walls. Iron mine, which I could actually fucking build with this builder, which actually I'm going to probably ought to do with this guy. So that'll boost that, and that's sorted. I don't, you know, and own two galleys. Great. So the Great Library feels like... And look how far away it still is, though, right? I have to get another 8 turns and then build it. I mean, it also obviously does give me 2 science, per turn for 400 production and a great scientist point or whatever. Great. I mean, I don't know. It just feels like it's miles away. I think if you started off as a cultural sieve, like Rome, start with a monument, okay? And if they're slamming down this tree, really, like, bashed, like, really just bashing through it, and you build, like, a monument in every city you put... I think you actually almost get a monument in every city you put down. I think you might be able to slam into this really quick and then chop it out, and then everything's boosted, and you're like, boom, and it's, like, a really big science boost. But it feels like a kind of... It doesn't feel so all-in as the Great Library in Civ 5, but it certainly is something that, if it hasn't been built now, it's not worth building. Yeah. I don't know, like, the other thing I've been doing a little bit of is obviously destroying all of my resources. Now, I could have destroyed more. I could have eaten that rice. I could have destroyed this stone. And sometimes you have to think about, you know, what's, is it worth it? You know, because obviously this rice is going to give me plus one food for a long fucking time. You know, 300 turns or whatever. Or, well, at least 55 turns so far. If I destroyed it, I would have got maybe 30 or 40 food out of it. So, you know, is it worth it? I don't know. Anyway, let's chop this fucking forest down. Give myself 59 production towards Petra, which has apparently sped up the production by fuck all. Oh, I see, because it was working. It was actually working that forest tile for two production. That's why it slowed it down. All right, let's buy up. Let's wait a turn. And then we'll buy up this fucking tile for it to... Jesus Christ, I'm just going to, like... Let's just keep chopping down these woods. Maybe I'll get it done before I have a problem. We'll see, won't we? Barbarians have a habit of, like, leaving their camps, which is really interesting. Which is, like, and shit. For them. I think I'll settle here. Seems like the right place. Cool. Then I can build an industrial district here and an industrial district here. I can chop this down. I love chopping stuff down so much. We are going to build in London. See, I'm glad Greece has settled it. Fine. There is a chance that we're going to be warred. Greece, Alexander likes to war. But my feeling is that we should probably build a spearman, because it actually boosts one of our things. And also it is a unit that doesn't... So, you know, it's a unit. It is a unit. It sure is. We are going to go and over here. All right, you're a scout. You need to explore automatically my world for me. Toronto, cool. Just doing Canadian things. Here's the spearman. I think that should have boosted one of the techs. Maybe I'd already searched it. Who cares? We've got so much production here. We can just slam stuff out. Let's build another builder. And I still got the build builders tech, I think. The cheap builders. I think I have. Yeah, so I can still build builders on the cheap. Let's do that. This is 27 turns away. We're going to carry on chopping down all the fucking forests. And we're also going to buy up this tile and get Manchester to work it. Which they are. And that's 18 turns now. Okay, Petra, get in there. Get in there, slowly. We might get it. That is my two harbours. So this is my Royal Navy Dockyard. Royal Navy Dockyard. Doesn't look like much, does it? Looks like a little dick on the end there. And that is that. Queen Victoria loves her dicks. It's true. Leeds. Builder. I guess. Probably a settler. Ugh, I don't want to build settlers. Fine, we'll just build settlers. Maybe I'll do trader, actually. We've got 4 trade routes. Ah, yeah, okay. So you get a spare trade route for building them. That's why I was building them. I remember now. Let's... Oh, shit, I can't buy up this tile. Let's sleep this builder. Or maybe just... Maybe cut down this fucking rainforest. God, I love to cut things down. I'm a monster. But that's what the pyramids is allowing me to do, really. It's allowing me to make this super efficient. 59 production. For a tile, 2 tiles out of my fucking area. That he might want. He might think, oh, that's my tile. Nope. I just chopped it down, bitch. How do you like that? So that's potentially something you can do to fuck over your friends in multiplayer. They can think, oh, look, I've got all these lovely resources like rice. You can just run your workers in. Harvest them up. I can see that being like a real point of contention, actually. I think people would have to really do it on the sly. Can you imagine that, though? Like, it's like imagine there's 2 stone on the... Imagine there's like 2 stone on the border of... You know, well, maybe just
easy way to train.
I think it only works if they're in your tiles, though, right? I think it doesn't work if... I don't think you could harvest them if they're outside 3-tile radius of your city. I mean, I think what they probably ought to do is make it so you can only do it within your borders. I think that probably needs to be changed. But it's not going to be changed forever or at all. Anything I suggest will never get changed because, unfortunately, often this game is a bit fire and forget. Like, all the Civ games are treated like that. They're sort of like, hey, we made a game. Here it is. And they don't tend to balance patch it necessarily. But maybe they will with Civ. Maybe they will with this. Maybe they will with this. Because, please, I would love you to. We have got nothing cool to build. I suppose we could build a district. Oh, that's right. We're going to build a commercial hub here. 5 gold turn. Big fucking deal. Harvest that. This is guarding our site. Scouts won't capture my settlers, so I don't need to worry about that too much. I should probably consider like moving these guys back at some point. And also scouting the rest of this map, really. A bit later than I haven't done it. And I'll build it. Sure. Let's go and build here. Get some more farms. Ah, and I probably should do with some more districts. So I could either get some gold out of my market. I still could get a lighthouse, which is not the worst. I'm England, though, so I do want to win by culture. All right, I've just remembered this is how we win the game. Okay, culture. Now, this gets culture for every adjacent wonder. So, when we build on here, we can build it between 2 wonders, and that would be fucking awesome. We can probably, 1, 2, 3, we can probably build it here. Let's go and chop that down and build a theatre district here after we chop the forest down. Oh, that forest is a bit awkward. I think this is a bug, actually. I think I found this before when I was chopping stuff down. 5 turns till Petra. What else do I want here? Oh, I want an industrial zone there. I think we definitely want an industrial zone. And that will be not terrible. I guess, like, I'm saying it's not terrible in a sense because I don't know how much I rate this stuff. Let's build a fucking mine here, I guess, for no reason. I guess these tiles will get worked eventually, and having stuff on them is fine. I'm building this city here, aren't I? Yeah? I mean, I could build one, like, here. It wouldn't be the worst. Here is quite greedy in terms of land. I don't really need so much land. I think you can... I think in this game you can... Especially with certain civs, like Japan, you can build much tighter empires. I mean, for example, this has left a lot of space up here. And I could squeeze a city on there if I was crazy. I don't know. I still haven't quite decided how tightly squeezed up to make things. Because at the moment, obviously, three tiles out from the city is here, three tiles out from the city is here. So there's almost no overlap, in fact, between these two cities. And that's okay. But it's not necessary. Having a little bit of overlap is okay because you can intertwine your districts and they get bonuses from that. You know, so sometimes, for example, if I built two cities quite nicely close, I could actually build, imagine I built this city here and this city was slightly closer to it. I could actually build like districts behind each other. So like this district's holy site, for example, could be three tiles out. So this, I basically, if I built that here and this one up, if I settled London where it started and I built Bristol like here or here, I could build this one's industrial site here and this one's industrial site here. And so they would almost be like interlocking a bit better. You don't have to do it like that, but you can. And it's certainly an interesting idea because I could use, for example, an encampment on this city, like here. And if I built this up here, this encampment would like defend this city much more effectively. So I would need like, you know, I could use a high production value city with an encampment in it to protect a different city. I mean, and they're all districts, right? So an encampment will buff an industrial district or any other district. So it looks like I might be able to get Petri, you know, at this current rate. We'll see. Where am I building? I am building here a builder. Oh, God. I hate scouting. I think scouting is one of the things I just hate doing. I don't do enough of it. It's so annoying to, like, have to do it all the time. 61 production. Bam! Free district! How good is that? I think chopping is, like, so, so powerful. This guy's got two builds. We will move him here and sleep him. And we'll move this guy back here. Sleep. Fortify. Sometimes fortify doesn't actually... The hotkey doesn't work. So I have to manually press. A lot of the hotkeys don't seem to work in this build. I'm sure that'll be fixed on release. Scythia is very impressed with me on how happy I'm keeping people. Well, currently have a pretty good score. Greece are catching up, though. Maybe I need to set more cities. Let's build a market. Amenities are low, though, and housing is really low. Crazy. Still have to build that granary, that's why. Right, situations. The End of Queen subscribe, thank you. D.I. Dishy, hello, good sir. MCM is next week. Have you bought yourself a sexy, stripy sailor shirt yet? Can't wait to see you in the outfit. D.I. Dishy made me a... Zephyr's jacket for me to wear. I need to get the stripy shirt. And I said, do you have any suggestions? And she literally Googled one online and said, this one is a sexy stripy sailor shirt. And I was like, wow, it's a good choice. So I'm actually looking forward to it. I haven't bought it yet. I will get one. I need to get some trousers as well, and I guess some boots or something like that. Who knows? I will read some more when Sam or Steve get back, because I think they're going AFK. See you next week. Thank you very much. New subscriber Despicable Babble has subscribed. Thank you. And Palantir Gaming. Thank you. Also, XXJordanXX. Lemon Cube says, iron your shirt. This is actually legit. You don't need to tell me that. Sepinox has subscribed to the channel as well, thank you. And Skedora donated $5. Hey Lewis, just wondering what you think about the tech tree. Watching a bunch of videos seems a lot shorter with dead end techs and a lot less late game stuff. Loving the stream, by the way. Thank you, man. Well, I think, like, as far as the tech tree goes, right, it feels pretty short and it feels pretty stumpy. Like, it feels like once you start getting into the meat of it, like tanks and stuff, it ends. It feels like it needs almost a whole... First of all, I think the science counts for these are probably too low, actually, for these high-end techs. They're too similar, you know, in these, like, in that this requires 700, this only requires 1,000. You know, it feels like that should be a much, much bigger difference. You know, that requires 600. This is barely twice as high. But by the time you've gone from, like, the modern era up into the end of the game, it should be like, okay, this should be over now, right? Oh, so let's try out this bug. So Petra needs 8 more. Okay, I'll wait. 8 more, and it's going to take 2 turns. That's annoying. This industrial district needs 40 more. It's going to take 2 turns. So that's the difference in production between these 2 cities. But once Petra's online, God, I'm a bit scared, though. 2 turns. It's turn 63. Someone might else be getting Petra. Oh, I claim a great person. A great admiral. Ugh. Grants 1 promotion level to a military naval unit. I might as well recruit him, because no one else is getting great admiral points. And if I press pass, then I can't get another great admiral until someone else gets this guy. And I can't get this guy in any way, shape, or form at that point, because I've passed him. I can't even buy him later. I don't know whether it's a bug, but I had this problem because the other day, I was the only person generating great merchant points. I bought a great merchant. I was generating shitloads of great merchant points. I passed on one. No one else was fucking getting great merchants. And by the end of the game, I couldn't get one. I had like 1,000 great merchant points and no one spent it on. So I am going to recruit this guy rather than passing and just leave him here, because I'm probably going to get the next one as well. So we're going to just fucking send him out here, sleep him, and wait until we get a naval unit. Let's build a... Has this guy built a builder? No, let's get builder and get the naval stuff set up. Let's wait a turn on this guy. Let's heal this guy. He's healed. I said wait, damn you. I need to get loads of trade routes, actually. That's what I should be doing, probably.
One man's magic is another man's engineering.
An aqueduct. About time. Right, let's buy up this... 100 gold. I do spend a lot of money on... I spend all my gold on tiles, and I spend all my production on builders and chopping stuff down. I have to wait with this guy again. I could go and chop that rainforest down. One turn and both of these things will be done. That's great. I'll get that tech. It's really cheap. So I'm up to 5 cities.
Petra is a brilliant display of man's artistry in turning barren rock into majestic wonder.
Oh, good old Petra. Goat N11 has resubbed. Thank you. Oh, no, Goat N. 11 months resub. That makes sense. We're going to have to wait for Steve to get back, actually. Man, love a bit of Petra. Look at those fucking torches. This is what I was trying to build in Druids Downtown, but... doesn't look anything like it. It still needs to be so orange. Sorry, let's just slap some finished ancient walls. I still haven't finished those. I never finished the ancient walls. I think I got aqueducts without even needing the tech. So look at this. Leeds will get 4 production from beginning a trade route with... That is incredible. 4 production. I sound like a fucking massive nerd saying that. That's a lot from a trade route, though, right? So we're going to build our industrial district. Fantastic. We're going to get... we haven't built any of these. We're going to build an Iron Man at some point. Probably not going to build castles anytime soon. Alhambra needs to be built adjacent to an encampment district. Gives +2 amenities from entertainment. So it's like, it gives you happiness and a military policy slot. So I guess if you're warring away, that might be a legit thing. But I feel like the encampments are pretty weak. I don't know what I'm going for science-wise at the moment. I'm not sure quite. I guess I should be going for culture, right? So what helps you with culture? Not very much, actually. The culture buildings tend to be... in the other tree. I guess I could build a university. Hagia Sophia, relevant, that's for a religious victory. this is a dead end tech that I definitely never want to take, but I will end up accidentally taking it, I'm sure, by accident at some point. Cartography gets me frigates. I could own the waves with frigates if I get shipbuilding, which I really can't be asked to get because I don't want it. This lets me build multiple ships. We used this in me and Duncan's playthrough with the Vikings. It's pretty decent. The Great Zimbabwe. This might actually be okay. Let's head towards the Great Zimbabwe because it might be fun. Right, we're gonna head towards that. We haven't got great scientists. We're not gonna be able to buy one. So actually, how many great scientist points are we towards one? Not any. So we might as well just do that because we're never gonna get the boost otherwise. Workshop actually is a legit thing. It's annoying when you build something, it stops telling you what it fucking does, and there's no way to see. I have to until I change, like, off of it, build something else. So, like, if I build a workshop, plus two production, that's all. And a great engineer point. Yeah, I mean, it's not a big deal, is it? Maybe I should get this theatre. Oh, I don't have enough tiles yet. Yeah, that's right. I'm building it here, and I have to chop this. All right. So what we'll do is we'll build the workshop. We'll chop this tile, and we'll see what happens. So this tile, Petra's done. So let's build bollocks! I bought the wrong tile. I should have bought this tile. What else do I want to build? I probably want to build a. I think actually. See, now these are great. These are great tiles. Look at these. These are the improved tiles from Petra. Desert Hills are legitimately fine tiles. I can build mines all over them. It'll be great. I'm actually going to build another commercial hub, and I'm going to build it. I think I could build it here just fine. I was going to build it here. Oh, I see. Because this tile, I think, is overlapping. No. Why can't I build it here? Let me see. Is it because this tile is not shared? No. Can I not build it a commercial district on floodplains? That seems unlikely. What's the reason why I can't build it here? I don't know. I'm going to build it here instead. Fuck it. And then we're going to build our theatre district here. All right, so watch this, right? So this is 5 turns away. This is 15 turns away. I'm going to harvest this for us, so it should give 66 production something. Okay, it did work. It gave it to this city. Previously when I did this, it actually gave it to nothing. I think it was equal. But maybe these aren't equal, because maybe this is not quite equal. Maybe this is like diagonally whatever, or this is like fuck knows whatever. Maybe it's not quite equal. I was going to report it as a bug, but it's no good if I can't replicate it, is it? There goes my bug report. See, I was thinking, like, holy shit. They're going to be like, wow. Lewis reported a bug and everything. But this might not actually be a bug. And also, I couldn't replicate it. Are you there, Steve? XXX Aiden has subscribed. And Arp Lee has subscribed. Cheers, you guys. Vozilla has subscribed. And Gent Levendetta subscribed. Thank you, guys. It's great. I'm glad that you subscribed. We're going to probably consider running some ads on the channel at some point. I haven't figured out exactly when or how or if we're going to do it at all. But I think I'd also like to try and up the quality of these streams a bit and do sort of more like not a regular Civ game, but like kind of a occasional Civ game or occasional like multiplayer special events. I'd like to do some like adventure books and stuff. I mean, we usually do these stuff around Christmas anyway, and we will do at Christmas. And also, I don't want to make the everyday streaming too difficult for us. And also, I don't want to make the everyday streaming too good, because then when Christmas comes around, everybody's like, oh, I'm bored of all this good stuff. Is that how it works? I don't know. Steve says the Christmas ones are special because of the amount of alcohol. That is very true, Steve. Horrendously so. I need to change my government to stop building wonders. Let's go to Great People Points. And we will also slap in some better policies now. So let's get some more envoys. We're going to keep building builders because, my God, we love builders. And this is what I was talking about with the Holy Site adjacency bonuses, right? there's some real potential to make this really strong if you have a lot of shit. But I don't really have that much value from my one campus. Maybe the commercial site of JCT Bonus will be good, because then that'll be from 5 it'll go to 10, so then I'll have both the commercial sites will be 10, and that'll be quite a lot at that point, which might be worth it. Am I going to build any more settlers? No. Am I going to buy some tiles? Maybe. Am I going to need more housing? Yes. Let's do that. So a bit of extra housing will keep me growing. Oh, look at all that copper. See, how come I didn't start here? Look at that. If you built a whole industrial site here. Oh, look at all that production. So much production. No one's declared war on me, so I'm not having to worry about that. Market. Settler. Shall I cut down my last wood? I feel like I should leave it there. It's like a national park. Although I'm not actually going to probably... Oh, I might build a national park. I'll probably build a national park. Like here, maybe. So national parks build in diamonds, I think. Like, and you have to, if you found a national park here, it covers like 4 squares. And you can put mountains in them. So it's a good way to use your mountains. Because mountains are the unworkable tile. 6 envoys. Do I actually get a bonus for that? Plus 2 science in every campus district. Bam. Plus 2 science, baby. Not too shabby. Not too shabby. Making farms, making explores. Right, let's actually try and burn through some turns here, because we haven't done hardly any turns in the last little while, because we've got a little bit too much on and we're thinking a bit too much about placement of stuff. So we want a theatre square, and we're probably going to put it here. It's not near any districts. Oh, we could just put it here. That only gives us plus 1 culture though. That does involve killing this fucking... That does involve killing that jungle, which I have to do before I go down. I refuse to build a district without farming that... Why is there still a tribal thing alive at, like, 1 million AD? I don't know. We're going to build an entertainment district, actually. We're going to build it here. And I think 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, that'll over that with that. Nice. We're going to come... Send that guy to cut this down. I think he'll be there slightly sooner. We'll build a mine there. Right, cool. So our progress towards guilds has increased. I think that's because we're researching feudalism, I think, or something like that. We really need theatre districts. So let's think about building those. We're going to build a theatre district here, and we're probably going to build a harbour here. Or maybe we should just build a harbour district straight away. Because it gives us another trade route, which we're not using efficiently at all. We're still at 1 out of 5. Okay, let's build some traders. That's not a trader. That's a spot. You got a worker. All right, let's go and work this. Okay. We're not going to build any more settlers, okay? Brilliant. Reconnaissance unit. I'll just have that on explore. It's fine. And I'll have you on explore too. We're not going to build new wall settlers, even though we would have expanded here, blah, 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 and here. Fuck knows. And I'd expand everywhere if I could, right? But we're going to treat this as if it's a real game of Civ rather than, like, as if this was the lands I got. And would I want a war at the moment? No. I'm going culture. I've got enough land. I wouldn't want a war. I don't need to take any more land, I think. You know, someone might want to come and take my land, but overall, I think, let's assume, I mean, is this a bonus resource? No. You can only remove the improvement. Interesting. Vilnius will give us plus 2 culture. Handy. Probably do with getting a bit of culture together, actually. Barbs are attacking someone else. Let's just get some roads going, because some of these places aren't roaded up properly. I'll just build loads of traders and chop down this rainforest. And then build I can't build another district until I've got population 10. Okay, that's not actually too far away. I do probably want to build a few more farms, though. So, otherwise I'll be 14 turns till I can get enough housing together.
Invincibility lies in the defense.
That's fine. Do I want to change my civics? No. Civil service, plus one amenity proceeds with garrison unit. You see, he receives plus one culture. Meh. Claim a great person, a great merchant as well. Increases trade route capacity by one. Foreign trade routes to the city provide plus two gold to both cities. There is someone else getting great merchant points, but this one is fine. We'll take it. We'll shove him in of our dude. He's going to give us another trade route. We're up to six now. We need to make use of these trade routes way better than I am. That's something I need to learn to do. Cool. Alright, let's just keep smashing out traders then. And if I fill up the capital with traders, then I'll put them somewhere else. Oh, I can put one here. Handy. You probably would like to build... You've already built builder. So we're going to go harbour here, commercial district here. Can I buy up that? Sure. Commercial hub. Sweet. And then we'll get to work on these cows. I'm taking towards the Great Zimbabwe, which I think's cool. If I get more culture, hopefully it'll help with my border expansion. That's one of the things, like, I spent so much gold on buying up tiles. I'm just constantly doing it. Six production when these two cities trade together. That's mad. Six production. I don't know why it's so much. Let's get another trader. So you don't need really an industrial district if you have really good trade. Because six production is way it's more than that production, more than the industrial district and the workshop are giving me. It's not because this isn't giving me a percentage bonus or anything. It's just giving me a flat two or three. It's really, really different from Civ to the other games. One more build on this guy. Kind of want to work this silk. So let's spend loads of gold. Yeah. Maybe keeping that gold
betwixt the stirrup and the
cheaper gold. Alright, send a trade route to Athens. Sure. How many more trade routes have I got? One more. Oh no, I can't. I'm building one here. Okay. I'm out of slots. Out of slots. I want the theatre square. And I wanted to build it here, I think, didn't I? That's where I was actually going to build it. So let's do that. Did I have a cow here? No, I didn't. And then with Manchester, after I finish this commercial square, I'm going to buy that one and build a square. He wants to give me a great work. Holy shit. What the fuck?
No.
The fuck, Pericles? I didn't realize you were such a cool guy with a really, really banging beard. So that's he actually gave
all
me.
Papers and forms. The entire civil a service great work is like of a fortress writing. Made of papers, forms, and red tape.
I can't believe it. That's never happened. Well, this is going to make my tourism victory very straightforward. We are just going to plow onwards towards our eventual mission to take over the world. He is. Now building an arena, that's cool. We will continue just building all sorts of random crap. He's finished his commercial district, so let's buy up this tile and build a theatre square in it. Which gives a lovely plus two culture. It will actually give plus three because it will be adjacent to two districts. And then if we build another district here and another district here, which we might not be able to do. We might be able to build another wonder. Who knows? So these benefit from being next to wonders. So if we can cluster them around together, it'll be really good for our win conditions. We should probably just leave this guy AFKing until this expands. I'm surprised I haven't set these up because they're good production tiles. We finally met Germany, who clearly is on a different map to us. He's fucking miles away. I didn't realise he was letting me in. Library. Sleep. Next turn. So it might be worth thinking at some point about...
With the advance of feudalism came the growth...
About this tech, which I completely neglected. Because that gives me the crossbows. But, yeah. Maybe I'll just go for the Great Zimbabwe first. So this one needs the Guild Civic, which I'm fucking miles and miles and miles from, probably. 4 tiles away from. Okay, so let's change this up. I've already started to boost it. It'll just finish when I get the Guild Civic. So let's get machinery, ironworking, and military engineering, and consider building an aqueduct somewhere. We can claim a Great Admiral again. See, this is what I'm saying. Another fucking Great Admiral. Just because I have harbours. So I'm just going to keep getting these guys. If I retire him, I get a free envoy. Might as well. So we'll slap him in to one of these new places that we just met. Zanzibar looks good because they're going to give us golden commercial hubs and we're going to need that eventually. What's the suzerain bonus with them? I don't fucking know. We'll find out. One of our policies got improved and that's why it got taken out. So here we go. Newly trained builders now gain 2 extra actions. So now our builders are worth 6 actions each. Which seems like a lot, doesn't it? And that's because it is a lot. It's twice as much as normal. Heracles is now just like being a hard ass about nothing. Imagine just Duncan saying, that city state, I've got my eyes on it. Don't mess with it. Oh, maybe it's because I put the point into gold friendship with
the Lord made his all.
Oh, I didn't realize. He must have seen me put a point into Zanzibar. Maybe he's the suzerain of Zanzibar. Is that how you say suzerain? I don't know. Zanzibar unique bonus. Received cinnamon and cloves luxury sources. They provide 6 amenities each. I'm not sure what 6 amenities each is. Oh, I guess it means it's 6 copies of them. So you can apply it to 6 cities. That makes sense. I just figured it out as I said it. We are going with a theatre zone here, which we'll buff all that. This guy is going to build a theatre zone here. And then we're just going to take over the world with our British museums. And Congo, we found him as well. I guess our scouts are just still exploring the world. Right, so we need to build 3 more trade routes. We met Trajan as well. Everyone is piling in. It's good to see you all. How are we doing on score against all these guys?
Remember that people break down too.
We are doing fine. Greece is our neighbour, and they're the scariest by a lot. It's really interesting how well they're doing. I thought I'd be like way out in front now, but I mean they don't really. I'm not exactly scared of these crossbows. Look at this fucking scout here. Settler here. Holy shit, look at his expanse. See, it's fun. It's weird, though. He might be a bitch to us. We'll find out. I don't really care about faith, so I'm just going to leave those. All right. He wants some stuff in return for open borders and a bit of gold. I suppose I probably have him free anyway. So we'll not worry about it. Keep them sweet. I'm not planning on playing the military game. Maybe I should just build a couple of bits of military units just to deter him, but not in my capital. Where's the Great Zimbabwe? Have I researched that yet? No, I'll get it at guilds, won't I? I'll just have it next turn. So let's build a... my housing is at capacity. I could really do with an aqueduct for the extra 2 housing, but that does get rid of this +5 food tile, which kind of sucks balls, actually. I could slap down another district, like an entertainment district here, which wouldn't be horrible. It's not fantastic though either. Fine. It's not like that tile's much good anyway as it is. Shit. Okay, that's a surprise war from Pericles. This happens, right? This occasionally happens. It's a formal war. That's very polite. And Rome. Anyone else? No, just you two. Cool. Right. Well, I mean, fine, I guess.
If you're the bank 100, every man should make his son.
All right. Before I do anything else, I just want to see if I've got any cows anywhere so I can build the Great Zimbabwe somewhere. This is a cow. Oh, milk is cow, isn't it? Milk bowls are cows. So I've got a cow here. Let's build. Oh, the chicken pizza. That's not what I want. The chicken. Ah, okay. I need a market. So after I've built the commercial hub, I'll build a market, and then I'll build the Great Zimbabwe here, and I can chop all these trees down to rush it out. That is if I don't die to Pericles before that point. Should I finish off my ancient walls? Yeah, why not? And let's buy something. I've got shit tons of gold coming in now. So let's buy a crossbowman. And we will also bring up my spearman. We'll also move this guy. 130 of gold for promotion. Yeah, shit. Let's bring this guy down just to help out. Is there not a road here? Fuck me, there's enough traders going around that we thought we would have a fucking road by now. Let's bring these guys back and we can promote these crossbowmen, and then we can hold this guy up really, really fucking easily. Unless he's got higher tech than us, which is possible, but feels unlikely. Plus 100% theatre district agency bonus as well. That's pointless, isn't it? A little bit of extra culture. That's trivial. A scout. I guess I'm at war with Jerusalem now. Because he's the suzerain. That's why this. Oh, I see. These are at war with me. Right. Okay. Oh, he captured a worker. Shit. He's got a heavy chariot there. Didn't even see it. The game crashed. That can happen. Let's do some donations. Chunk. K2 has subscribed. L Garden has subscribed, resubscribed for 7 months. Thank you, man. Daniel SB, you know how when you can't hear game sound with SIPs in Steam streaming? If you tab out, you'll see it muted on the speaker icon on the taskbar. Unmute it there. I don't know why, but it just mutes it every time you start streaming. It happened to me before. Yeah, I have noticed that. Thank you. That's a good suggestion. Captain Androck. Hey Lewis, what is your opinion on the new Civ leaders? Great stream so far, keep it up. My opinion is that I love some of them and hate some of them. I can very quickly go through it with you. What time is it? We've got half an hour left. All right. So, for example, Germany, Free Imperial Cities just feels bad, right? This whole game, there's like maybe twice that I've said, oh, I'd like to build a district, but I can't until I have more population. But that's happened like twice. And quite frankly, I was able to build the district either the next turn anyway, or like I didn't fucking need it. So having an extra district, almost worthless. Holy Roman Empire, attacking six states. How much of that have I done? None. How much of that do I want to do? Probably none. But maybe a bit. Like if for example it turns out that, like, you know, we start a multiplayer game and I've got a land and I've only got three cities, fuck it, I'll get those three archers at start, I'll send them, I'll go attack the six state, blah blah. U-boat, so late game that it's irrelevant. Hansa, Union District of Germany for industrial activity. Like, what does it give me? It doesn't actually say what it does here, but I don't think it does very much. I think it might give, like, if it gives a good adjacency bonus. I don't know what it does. Maybe I'll look it up in a second. Norway is like an amazing early game rush civ, okay? And also the Stave Church is actually probably more legit than I give credit to, because it gives additional standard adjacency bonuses from woods. But I think the Stave Church is a bit tricky to build. I think you have to build it in a holy site after you've built a shrine, and it's like, oh God, it's a little bit tedious to actually get the fucking thing built. So, you know, and you're not necessarily going to be building total size in every single city. So, not convinced really about the Stave Church. The Longship, early game unit, Berserker, half decent unit, but it loses combat strength when defending in multiplayer. How is that a good thing? Like, you know, you're always going to be getting slammed into. People will know that your Berserkers are weak, so you're just going to get them chopped to bits very quick. You know? Bad. Japan seems like the most OP civ in the fucking game right now, because Meiji Restoration, or Meiji? One of those pronunciations is correct. All districts receive an additional standard JC bonus. That is so powerful, because you think, right, okay, I've got a industrial district, right? I'm not going to put it near any of my fucking mines or quarries. It's better to just stick it in the middle of a load of other districts, because it will just be more, it'll just be better. Like, if I put it, surround it with six other districts, it'll be six production, right? Whereas, like, and also, Japan's electronics factory is the factory that goes in the industrial district. It gives plus four production to all cities within four tiles. So, like that triangle thing I was talking about earlier, if you slap a bunch of industrial districts in the middle, like maybe even next to each other, so they benefit from their industrial district bonus, like they're next to each other, put electronics factories in them, it's just an incredible amount of production across a small area. It's so good. This is such a good civ. Like, I think these are the strongest civ at the moment, if you build properly. Congo, the Nikisi is either so late game it's irrelevant, and by the time it's late game, plus two food, plus two production, plus four gold from a relic or an artifact is a trivial amount, so crap. Religious Convert, you can't even build holy sites. This actually makes them worse. This actually is a negative benefit to their civ. It actually doesn't help. The Swordsman replacement, you never use, because you see like one iron on the whole map, and you need. I've seen one iron today. There's so little iron anywhere that I've never built one of these, and it's garbage. And you're just, what's the point? Swordsman? Who uses Swordsman? No one. Let's carry on. Mabanza, it's replaced as a neighborhood. I talked about neighborhoods earlier. They're so late game that, like, apparently this is available earlier, but I'm yet to find good use for it. Maybe it's okay. Pericles gives you a wildcard policy start in any government, which is actually pretty good. And a lot of extra culture if you're going to be friends with six states, which is actually okay. The Acropolis is actually okay. And the Hoplite is actually okay. So these are actually all okay. Philip II, Inquisitors can remove heresy. One extra time. Whoop-de-fucking-do. Combat units have a bonus of philosophical combat strength against all players following other religions. That's usually going to be the case. So, like, seems okay. Conquistadors haven't used them. They replace musketmen. And they get a buff when you've got your religious guys following them, which is quite fun. Missions are pretty average as far as I've found. They give you, it's obviously a unique thing that you build in a tile. It gives you plus one faith and plus one science if built next to a campus. That's not bad. Obviously, there's not going to be that many slots near your campus that you want to put missions nearby. You'd rather have other districts near them, or rainforests or mountains or whatever, so. But, you know, might not be terrible. Roosevelt gets... Founding Fathers is to do with, like, that thing where when you get a new government, basically the way it works is that it normally ticks up over time. So it'll be, like, 10% wonder production plus an extra 1% every six turns or whatever. You get it twice as fast. So I think it ticks up quicker, but it's such a trivial bonus that it's kind of irrelevant. They get plus combat strength on their home continent. That means that when they're defending, they're stronger. That's actually not bad. And that's it, though, really. I think you get later in the game, you obviously get a bit of culture, which is nice. And the Rough Rider, I've never used it, but I'm sure it's great. Tamiris feels like the scariest fucking early game rush civ, like, in the world. Like, get horse archers that... When you build one, you get two. And so you build, like, two horse archers, and you have four horse archers. They move four. They have a range. One, they just start shooting like crazy. They are pretty scary units, actually. And also, all units get a bonus when attacking wounded units and heal when they kill one. So it feels like enjoy getting rushed by Tamaris and dying in like fucking 25 turns, guys, because that's what Tamaris will do to you. It's horrible. Trajan feels really, really, really broken because you start with monuments. So if you get a city down, it's got a monument in it, and you get a second city down quick, it's got a monument in it. That's so much culture coming in that you're just like rushing through the civic street in that early game. Really powerful. Legions are always average. Swordsman again, swordsman replacement. Aqueducts get an extra plus 2 housing and plus 1 amenity, so that's pretty good, because I'd like to build aqueducts. I don't think that they're very good unless you don't have fresh water already, but in this case they're always going to be, because you're always going to get at least plus 4 housing out of it, if not, you know, plus 8. So it's either plus 4 or plus 8 housing, which is a lot. And Victoria is who I'm playing at the moment, so if you conquer or found cities on a other continent, your home continent, you get a free melee unit. Apparently none of the ones I founded today were on home continent, even though I'm on Pangaea, which where the continents are pretty small. So I guess you have to settle quite far away. Sea Dog replaces the privateer, which is all well and good. And the naval Royal Dockyard lets you embark instantly off of the Royal Navy Dockyard, which the Viking one you can just do. You can just embark fucking anywhere. Like you could ignore embarking and disembarking for your entire civ. So it's like, yeah, here you can do it from the city only. But it's cool. You could just like rush a load of armies out onto the sea and, you know, rush off to attack a foreign nation. It's cool. It's a cool idea. I just don't think it's much good. That is that. Let's see if I can get this autosave loaded up. Oh, it might have been a little while ago. From the first stirrings of life, I don't know how long ago it was. So that's my opinion on the civ leaders that are in here that I've played. I can't really tell you about the others because I haven't played them, so I don't know how they play out. But certainly, Rome feels really different to play because it's so strong. I'm sure Egypt and China will feel very different to play because they can use builders. That's my favorite thing about builders, destroying stuff, slamming like production into stuff. It feels awesome. Victoria, did I say Elizabeth? Sorry, I meant Victoria. Has he declared war on me yet? Doesn't look like it. Great. Cheats, guys. Super hacks. I could tell the future. Oh, someone's going to declare war on me. That's what happens. Oh, and another person after that. Is it going to happen? Wow, I'm psychic. The oracle told me. Thank you. I didn't bother moving anyone else or fixing anything else. I'm just going to let them take my worker again. I saw a bank. Oh, it's Rhythian. 24-hour bank. Every man should make his Rhythian says, hey man, feel free to run over a little bit if you have the time. Got to finish rendering my Civ 6 video. Anyway, I ended up recording a 2-hour session because I forgot to stop. That's the problem with this game, friend. Just one more turn. Can I get this guy out of the way before he takes it, maybe? I think I probably want to just upgrade that guy and then start shooting this guy. I know I want to buy up a crossbowman here. Is he sending a builder to attack me? That's crazy. You crazy. So I think having a crossbowman is so I can build the Great Zimbabwe now. And I think I could have also changed my civics, which I probably should have checked before I did that. I think I got this one. Oh no, here, these are the two I got. Industrial Zone adjacent to Commercial District Hub adjacent to. Man, I should probably put those in. Let's get rid of plus one production in all cities, because it's kind of a little bit irrelevant now. But I'm going to keep this because, I love building builders. Right, so that's going to boost my gold per turn. So I'm now getting 86 gold per turn, which is pretty fucking fabulous. I can build some more traders, so I'll probably do that. I don't think I have to worry too much about Pericles or Rome. First of all, you fucker, he ran through my whole base. Son of a bitch. Let's just... Oh, it's crashing. I've found a major bug in Civ 6, and it's causing it to crash now. I don't know what to do. I don't know what to do. I guess I could show you some of my other Civs that I've built, right? Could I do that? Or maybe I can do that. Man, I think we might be stuffed. I don't think we can carry on this save if it's going to crash like this. That's a shame. I was really getting into this. It's just, it must be the save. What's causing the crash? Rillian says, I don't know. What do you think it is? Because it crashed in exactly the same place last time when I had that guy down there. Did you see him?
From the first stirrings of
maybe if I disband that guy. I'll try it one more time. The great beasts R. Parker, 7 months 3 sub. Hey Lewis, if you had a chance to try any of the Anno games, like Rise of Venice or Anno 2070. Rise of Venice. I haven't played that. I've played Anno 1404 Venice, which I believe me and Pyrian played on Civ Channel. We played it co-op. It was amazing. I love Anno. It's one of my favorite games of all time. And I just love building. Now you've said Anno, I am going to... Wow, that's a really cool image, Steve. Thanks. Where is that? Where is that fucking guy who's causing this crash? Is he down here somewhere?
Hello.
I think he's the one causing the crash, but it might not be him. It might be one of these districts being built or something funny going on. I don't know. There's definitely something funny going on down here. See, now with the psychic Lewis, I can actually move this builder out of the way. Even earlier. Oh no, I can't, shit. It's going to be exactly the same fucking place. All of my psychic powers, they do nothing. Hopefully if I have these two crossbowmen, maybe he won't be able to go past now because of the zone of control. There's been two wonders built. Stonehenge. Alright, Pericles. And... Maybe they don't like me skipping their cutscenes.
If you're the bank $100, that's your problem.
Banking. The bank plus five gold. Oh, so much gold. So much cash. Cha-ching, baby. I love the old Petra. Look at this. This city's actually turned into a decent city because of Petra, even though I built it in the middle of what is effectively the worst place in the fucking universe. So yeah, I blocked him with zone of control. Fucking Civ pro moves. We will upgrade this, and we will send this guy over here and build a farm. Look at that, 5 food from that farm. And that's because it's adjacent to other farms, and we've got feudalism. So I think it's because it's adjacent to all these farms, it gets... It's that settler, it's that trader. I think it's a trader running out and coming back. I may have too many traders in the capital for it to handle. I've broken the game, guys. It's literally broken. I cannot carry on. Rillian, how long have you got till you can join me? It's all right, don't worry. I will... We tried, Rillian. How long have you got on your render and your upload? Because I can just keep going until you're ready, and then we can hand over. What's Rillian? What are you gonna play tonight, Rillian? You gonna do some WoW or some other stuff? What's on the plan? Oh, it's all right. Don't worry. I can fill. I've got loads of stuff to show off. Didn't I have a really good? Was this it? Weird, these are not my saves. I don't know what the save is.
The great beasts of the Stone Age.
The AI is just rage quit when they knew they couldn't win. That's right. New subs. Jigada, thank you. And Sabe, Sabe69, cheers. Crimson X28 resubbed. And so did Sounds of the Wild, thank you. Kirsty M19 subscribed. Sabe68, 69 says, finally submitted some work for my maths uni module. Thank you, Lewis. Believe it or not, you have managed to keep me sane throughout this emotional time. Ah. This is what I want to show you. Yeah, okay, this is it. So, this is a playthrough where I played as Japan. Okay? Now, I found this city-state early, and I started to get religion coming in. Okay? And what I did was, I had a pantheon early, so I built a... I got a pantheon early, and I got Tundra Faith. So normally when you got this start, you're like, fuck me. That's what you'll say when you get this start. You're like, this is garbage. And you know what? It is actually turn 34 and I'm still on one city. So maybe, do you know what? Maybe this start was actually garbage and maybe I've played this really badly. But I did play this through to the end and I was fucking OP as fuck. So basically, I'm next to Kilimanjaro, which gives me food for adjacent tiles. But I'm also, I got this big tundra-y start, and I put this holy site down here. And it's already getting six faith per turn. Okay. But then I got the adjacency. Then I put down a load more districts around it. And every district, in Japan's bonus is that you get bonus, adjacency bonus. So normally... normally, the way it works is, imagine I had a holy site here, right? And it was getting me six faith. If I put down two districts here, so I put down like a commercial district and a fucking neighborhood or an entertainment district or a theater district or whoever cares up there, right? This then would get seven faith, right? Because it's now getting one bonus adjacency bonus for having two districts next to it. Okay, and all of the major ones do that. So commercial districts get one bonus gold for two districts next to him. Culture ones, theatre ones get one bonus culture for two districts next to them. However, Japan gets an additional adjacency bonus for every adjacent district. So, in this case, if I built a commercial site here and a theatre site here, this would go from 6 to 7 because it would have one. But also, it gets Japan's bonuses, gets an additional JC bonus for everyone. So it would get 8, 9. So it would get 9 faith from that. Okay? If I put one here, it would go to 10. If I put one here, it went to 11, 12. If I put one here, it would go to 13. If I put one here, it would go to 15 faith per turn. Okay, and then if I use the thing in the tree, which doubles it, it's going to get me 30 faith per turn. So I built a city, I think, like here, or maybe, I think it was either here or here. And by the way, if you start with one of these fucking tiles in your capital, a 5 food tile, unimproved, what the fuck? Like, Jesus Christ, how powerful is that? A 5 food tile straight away. I mean, what? And you can, by the way, do that. Or if you start meeting out, like, so at one time, one game I played, I met up with 3 red city states. Now, the red city states give you +2 production, right, per unit you're building. So imagine I was building a unit here, right, and my production is 10. I will be getting 16 for building those units. But obviously, this is turn 34. I don't know what the fuck I'd be doing this game. Why do I have only one city that's tiny? Maybe it's because I've got this horrible plane start. Who knows? I think it partly is because I've obviously been pissing around in the tundra. God, this is a bad start, guys. I'm sorry. 34 turns. What was I doing? I don't know. Anyway. Yeah, this is a real opportunity to just get so much faith. And then when you have so much faith coming in, You could just buy great people for like cheap as chips. Like a great scientist is 550. I'm already at 250 and I'm getting 15 per turn. I could actually almost buy a great prophet for 280 faith. And that'll get me the old religion. But then after that, look, you know, other ones, merchants 550, cheap, cheap as chips. I wonder if I've actually got a save for this. So this is turn 34. Anyway, that's that. Thought you might be interested in seeing that. What else can I show you? I found a really bad start. I found like sometimes I like to just regenerate the map until you find a bad start, and then you think, oh shit, what the fuck am I gonna do with this bad start? And then every start from like then on is a good start, and you're like, oh good, this is a good start. If you end up with this though, you'll be like, oh my god. So this is a maybe a bad start. So what we have here is, it's not the worst. It's not the worst, okay? Because we could go the Tundra Pantheon, right? Like I just did, and get some holy sites going. But it sort of feels like the Tundra kind of ends, like, maybe here. I'm not sure. Like, let's have a look. Oh, there's more Tundra and shit ice. So maybe we can have another Tundra city. Maybe that's not the worst. And maybe also we're locked in our own area and we can't get out to the sea. Maybe that would be bad. That's something that used to happen. Submarines and stuff don't go under ice anymore, by the way, which is interesting. But look at the yields here, right? The yields are so fucking pitiful. Okay. I've got 1-2 food tile within 2 range. This is 2 out. It looks like it's on another coast. I mean, this is just such a garbage start. Like, these tiles are just absolute fucking trash. So what would I do here? So the classic build, right, for me, is to go scout into builder, which I can do. I mean, working a 2-food-1 production tile to begin with is not Hitler. But I would have much preferred something that wasn't garbage. I mean, if you're given this, like, you know, what do you fucking do? I guess what you do is you just abandon it. You just build a settler quickly and fucking hope that your second city won't suck as many dicks. Well, it looks like it's going to suck as many dicks. Now, one of the biggest problems, okay, with going the Tundra Pantheon, okay, is that you need to find a source of faith somewhere. Now, if you don't find a source of faith somewhere, holy sites don't generate faith on their own. They only generate faith through a... So imagine I went and built, you know, imagine I went and built a holy site, and I thought, oh yeah, I have the Tundra Pantheon, I'll build it here, right? Near to all this Tundra shit, and it'll be loads of faith, yeah, yeah, I'll be great. But that doesn't actually work because I don't have any faith coming in. And once I there's no way to get faith off of a holy site unless it's built either A, next to a mountain, or B, next to 2 woods. So if you build a holy site next to 2 woods, i.e. if I built it here, for example, or obviously I can't build it there, that's the only site. And that will give me 1 faith per turn coming in. So it will only take me a whole 20 turns to get myself a pantheon, by which time I'm sure the Tundra Pantheon will still be there because it's shit. But... just see what I'm getting at. So look, 6 turns to grow. Like, what are you doing here? Why are you now working this tile? It boggles the mind. I have to actually tell my city not to be garbage. But then again, even if I do get up to 2 population, I'm still like in a fucking shit state. Oh, that tribal goody heights up there. You know, in a dream world, this will have a relic in it, which will give me plus 4 faith, and then I'll just... No, it gives me 40 gold, which is almost worthless. However, it's actually not the worst, actually, because I can now probably extend this fucking... Can actually grab this, which is not a completely useless tile. Maybe I should have grabbed this, actually. I can grab that next. So now I'm not in a bad shape, actually. Suddenly... It's all looking up for old Lewis. No thanks. We'll be all right. Just let Rydian get ready for going. Oh shit, because Calf streams in here after me, doesn't he? Ah, crap. Rydian, tell me when you're ready, and I'll leave, because Calf wants to stream in here. But we'll Oh shit. I didn't think. I'm just experimenting. Let's see how this turns out. Everyone wants to know the gripping conclusion to the bad start.
But as I headed into the heart of
Pio Tahi. So yeah, this is a nice place to expand to. Apart from this barb camp in the way, which I guess I should probably deal with. So I'm thinking immediately, this is a garbage place. There's no river here. There's no river here. You know, there's no river here. Where, and there's no mountains. There's no oasis. There's no fresh water at all. What do I do? Well, I guess I could expand to here and build an aqueduct and keep it going granary early on. Probably not. We're going to go with this and try and get this one fairly soon. We can actually kind of upgrade our three tiles, not in a terrible fashion. But, so this is the problem right now. I've not found any faith coming in. This thing doesn't give faith. This actually tile does give faith. So if I had dyes, it would be okay. I haven't found a faith city state. I haven't found a relic. So that means I have to pick this if I want to get any faith anytime soon. Instead of getting a production, which I desperately need. And I just found another city-state that isn't religious either, which is actually kind of a relief, since I literally just chose. I can build a holy site, because I guess I messed up my build order slightly. Oh, no, I didn't, because I had it building. Okay, I did mess it up slightly, because I was showing off. Maybe I just grow here. And then, how long is that to grow? 4 turns, that's fine. And then start building a settler. Okay, so see how this works out. So if I imagine I had finished that on time and I wasn't an idiot. That would help me out with one production. That's fine though. See, what I can do here is something a bit stupid. This tile is kind of crap anyway, right? Imagine I took this tile and I improved it. Right? I still wouldn't want to work it. It's still bad. I improve it with a camp, plus 1 gold. I would still not work that tile. So, let's remove the deer instead, which seems like a really bad play, but actually it means I'm now getting settler in 3 turns. So I'm going to grow to 3. I'm going to get the settler done sooner than that. If I hadn't fucked up the build order, I'd probably have two on that right now. I'm slowly edging towards my pantheon, and when I get it, I can probably slap a holy site down here. No, actually here. I'll probably slap it here, then put an industrial zone here. And that'll benefit from these two. And then this settler can go and actually colonize somewhere that isn't total trash. Unfortunately, I think the only place that isn't total trash is going to be here. Oh no, shit, not here. It'll be here or here, because that doesn't count as a river. Alternatively here, but this is all just fucking plains and garbage. This is a horrible start, isn't it? I think this counts as fresh water. It does. So I could settle in literally the worst series of tiles in the universe. That would be honestly the worst thing I'd ever want. I don't want to do anything like that in my life. Let's Let's smash on. Alright, PJC subscribe, thank you. Bender03 says, you are 2MLG for Civ, Lewis. I know I am. DP the Vast has subscribed. Thank you, man. How you doing? I'm Didja. 4 month resub. Thank you. And SandJoe103 has also subscribed. Cities don't starve when building settlers. I don't think that's true anymore. That's the true in Civ 5. Is that true, Rithian? Is that true? Cities don't starve while building settlers. Oops. All right. Now, do I want to consider chopping down my only forest? Well, it is kind of shit, so I could do.
Who deserves more credit than the wife of a coal miner?
Now, I want to be very careful with my good tiles. So these are not great tiles, but they're actually... shit me. Well, that scat won't actually kill me. How far away do I want to move? And then again, it can't be further away than our last game, can it? Why are these guys green? Oh, because I guess they're on... Oh, that's a lake. Okay. We can go there. We can go on this lake. We can go here. This is great. I didn't realize it was a lake. I thought it was like another sea. Lakes are fresh water. So that's actually a really nice place. These guys won't capture my thing. I'm going to bring this guy back and fight this thing. What actually should I be researching? I don't know. Well, we're done now, basically. We're safe. We just move the settler away and we focus on that as our big city. And then we build another city and then we carry on. And we're out of the doldrums. And then we'll build our holy site in a million turns. No, we don't. We don't do it yet because we're nowhere near the Pantheon. 10 turns is a long time as well. Jesus. Build a builder. Hello, Trajan. And then hopefully we don't lose our settler as we move it around to the other side of this thing. Which is a thing that can happen. If we're really unlucky. Because we've explored the wrong way with our scout. He's sending us some cheese. Oh, look at this. A faith thing. I hate building without chopping it first, but I don't really have a choice. And honestly, like, it's not that much lost production. I can actually walk into Rome's territory, interestingly. That's another thing, without declaring war. I think you can do it with scouts. I think scouts can enter enemy territory, I think. Up until a certain tech, maybe. Maybe up until open borders is researchable. I don't know. I don't know what the rules for that are. But I find that interesting. And that's it. We're free now. We're home free. Are you kidding me? Is that too close to Rome? Oh, it's pretty close. Didn't realise. It's not actually that close. It's actually, do you know what? It's closer to me than it is to Rome, so I think that counts as one for me. He can settle here and have that. Or maybe I should buy it up. In a multiplayer game, I'd probably buy that up. Oh shit, there's a fucking horse archer. I think they're really weak, though. Not that weak. Well, there goes my warrior. Fucking rip. Jesus. I think he's probably dead. Because that horse archer's just going to walk and shoot. Unless he moves the horse first, I think. Harblaw. Jesus. Here we go. Well, continuing the bad luck. What happened to my worker? Oh, did he build that? No, he didn't. What happened to my other worker? I did that, and I chopped. Yeah, I chopped the deer down. He can chop this down just fine. Let's chop out another builder. I'm crazy! And then we'll do a slinger. I didn't boost craftsmanship. Should have boosted craftsmanship. It's the classic early game mistake. Fortunately, because I'm playing as good old England, I've got a really terrible culture. Alright. That's fine. So it's not unrecoverable, this. A bad start. It's not unrecoverable. It's fine, in fact. And I'm quite looking forward to getting my faith on as England. Get your faith on. We haven't seen a new continent yet. Which is kind of interesting. Because they're quite common, actually. Irrigation's done. I can now build a horseman. The horses. Signing. I found Signy, de Behemaha, Signy, de Behemaha. It is culture and science to adjacent tiles. It's like a bunch of spikes. It's kind of cool. Kind of cool. The earth is amazing, isn't it? It makes these things. How do you think that was formed? I don't know. Someone cast Earth Spike on it millions of years ago. Wizards who used to be alive. That's what I'd like to think anyway. Yeah, so I'm actually like getting out of the tundra, getting to work some of these tiles that aren't total garbage. You know, once this one's online, and I've expanded to it, it's actually not too bad. I can consider doing the Holy Site. Actually, the Holy Site would be actually fine here. Because these are all tundra. I'm actually on tundra. So I'm now getting in 3 faith per turn. Is that because I've met a religious city-state. So now when I next get this changed, which unfortunately hasn't happened yet, I can pay 20 gold to unlock it. Let's do it. I can change this back out. And also fight barbarians better. Pew, pew. Look at that. And I met another city state. And I was granted a free scout. And I could get Dance of the Aurora. Sweet. Now, when this is done in 5 turns, which will be no problem, work this tile. I might even chop this down to get it done faster. Should I bother? I do like chopping stuff down. Maybe I shouldn't. Screw it. Chop it down. We're going to chop everything down. Where is the oracle, actually? Because that's a pretty good wonder to have. It is... I think it's early. That's Stonehenge. Oh, it must be in the other tree. It is here. Okay. Man, I'm annoyed I haven't discovered a second continent yet. That's frustrating. So if I get the Oracle, Oracle basically means that buying great people costs 25% less faith. So, if I slap that down fairly early and grab it up, I can, all my faith gain, I can spend it on these guys a lot cheaper. And obviously, if I'm buying a lot of these guys up, look, you know, it's random boosts. It's like, you know, all sorts of stuff. Gain 40,000 gold. 40,000 gold. I'm not sure that's right. I think it's actually 40 gold. Activate on a tile that no player owns. Or activate next to a tile that you own. Your nearest city annexes this tile into its territory. Right. Okay, right, so basically you get 3, this is a merchant that gives you 3, I can buy up a tile, and it gives you 40 gold for doing so. So that's really cool, because I love to buy up tiles. So I just get the great merchant out, I'd be like, cha-ching, 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 loads of free gold. Fantastic. I feel like I've built a little bit away from these coppers. I can get that copper, But this, I can get it with that city instead. I can get this with that city instead. I could just harvest this one if it's. But then again, I think I might only be able to harvest it if it's in within three tiles. Sorry. How are you doing, Rillian? Oh, he's good to go. Cool. Right. In that case, I'm going to leave you. Thank you all for watching this stream. I hope you had a good time. I had a lovely time. I'll probably put this on the Civ channel, maybe, if you liked it. I'm going to try and put together a more succinct or ordered strategy guide with kind of the broken down, like, my thinking for how to get going with this game. Thank you to Nike007. Thank you to Mary of Blades. And also thank you to Refuge Gamer and Maycorp for subscribing to the channel. There's loads of benefits for subscribing. I'd love to list them all, but maybe we'll do that another time. Thanks for watching, everybody. We'll see you next time. Goodbye. To get high. Get fucked up! Get fucked up! Get fucked up! To get high. Get fucked up! Get fucked up! To get high. The whiskey's right here, Lewis. Put you a fat one. Big fat one. Get fucked up! Hey, don't hit the player. Hit the game. Game. Straight up G. Get fucked up! Get fucked up. Get fucked up. Get high. Get fucked up. Get fucked up. To get high. I've had fucking five whiskeys, like half a fucking advent, gin advent can of a five. Get fucked up. I've had fucking five whiskeys, like half a fucking advent, gin advent can of a five. Get fucked up. I've had fucking five whiskeys, like. Upstairs,
and there's some gin.
I'm not sure we can drink 2 litres of Jack Daniels.
We have an entire advent calendar of gin.
We're not allowed to drink that. Get fucked up. Get fucked up. Get fucked up.
To get high.
Get fucked up. Get fucked up. To get high.
Nothing excessive.
Nothing. Honestly, I think this has been a very reserved
and uninebriated
stream.
I think I drank less tonight than I would have anyway.